to one and all that are a part of this webinar. I thank you all for sparing your precious time and being a part of this webinar organized by HK Acharya & Company. I am Jalashree Dave, your host for this morning and a part of HK Acharya & Company at head office. Markpatent.org, Gujcost, DST, JITCO, CED, Gujarat National Law University, Institute of Law, Nirma University, LD Engineering of College, and Gujarat Chemical Association cordially greets one and all present here. We have gathered today to share our knowledge, ideas, and collaborate with our peers from the industries pertaining in the field of intellectual property. HK Acharya & Company was founded in 1977 by respected late Sri Hariprasad Acharya. We are an exclusive IP boutique. We offer all services, be it legal or technical insight, relating to intellectual property rights in India as well as international. We take pride to convey that HK Acharya & Company is now has extended its services to Mumbai, Rajkot, Morbi, Baroda, and Ahmedabad. It is the vision of Dr. Rajesh Kumar Acharya that we have also marked our presence in the global market by having various offices in various countries, that is Mount View, USA, China, Japan, and Canada. Now I would like to give a brief introduction about our organizers and co-organizers. Our organizers, markpatent.org. Markpatent.org is organized in 2004 as a based in the heart of the city. It is actively associated and dedicated to the support of advancement of intellectual property elements, that is trademark, copyright, patent, design, and cyber. The main objective is to create awareness of such laws among the general public. Next, DST, Department of Science and Technology, which was constituted in June 2002 to look after growth and development of new and emerging technology areas and is responsible for formulation and implementation of key sector in the state of Gujarat. Gujcost, the Gujarat Council on Science and Technology, and was established to play a catalytic role in promoting the use of science and technology in the development process of the state, as well as to make interactions between the users of technology by bringing on a common platform to training scientists and engineers on one hand and policymakers as well as administrators on the other. Next, CED, the Center for Entrepreneurship Development, a Government of Gujarat organization established in 1979, the center is engaged in promotion of skill and entrepreneurship across the state of Gujarat. The concept behind CED is to develop entrepreneurs in the urban as well as rural areas of the state, which can establish their own enterprises, which in turn aids in the economic growth of the state and also to create employment opportunities for others. JITCO, Gujarat Industrial and Technical Consultancy Organizations Limited, was set up in 1978 to render industrial consultancy services to new and existing enterprises in the state. It has graduated to providing its services to small and medium enterprises, larger units, government and semi-government institutions, and government departments covering both manufacturing and service activities. GNLU, the Gujarat National Law University, a public law school and a national law university, is located in the Knowledge Corridor of Gandhinagar, the capital of Gujarat. Formed in the year 2003, the university is based on the structure of the National Law School University, Bangalore. GNLU was the seventh national law university to be set up in the country. It was established with the active support of the Government of India, the Government of Gujarat, and the Judicial Fraternity. Institute of Law, Nirma University, founded in the vision of Padma Shri Dr. Karsan K. Patel, the Institute of Law, Nirma University, focuses on the offering a basal shift in the delivery of legal education in the country. It imparts quality education and has produced new generation lawyers, leaders, and policymakers over the years. LD Engineering College, Lalbhai Dalpatbhai College of Engineering, LDG in Ahmedabad, a premier government engineering institute in Gujarat state, set with the objectives of imparting higher education, research and training in various fields of engineering and technology. The institute is affiliated to Gujarat Technological University, Ahmedabad, and administered by Department of Technical Education. Government of Gujarat LD Engineering College was established on June 20, 1948 as one of the first few engineering colleges in India. GCA, Gujarat Chemical Association, was established in 1947 by a group of far-sighted individuals who could visualize the imminent change in the industrial scenario of the nation that had recently gained independence. It represents the interest to the entire gamut of chemical and its related products. GCA has also many members from the trading community, including the exporters and importers. Now, may I please welcome our dignitaries. Our chief guest, chairman and managing director of Wadilal International Private Limited, Mr. Devanshu Gandhi. Managing trustee of markpatent.org, Dr. Rajesh Kumar Acharya. Advocate and trademarks attorney at HK Acharya & Company, Mr. Ketan Bhatt. Director of Sri Vallabh Printers Private Limited, Mr. Dhaval M. Jhaveri. Creative director of H. Petals Creative Solutions Private Limited, Mr. Tejas Nair. And trademark agent of HK Acharya & Company, Mr. Saifullah Maulvi. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce you Dr. Rajesh Kumar Acharya, proprietor of our company. He is a patent and trademark attorney and is registered to practice law before Indian and Canadian patent and trademark offices. He is also the member of Bar Council of Gujarat, having an extensive background in the prosecution and litigation of all IP-related matters. He is the best known for his books on the IPR laws in India, that is the patent law, the trademark law, the copyright law, the biological diversity law, and the design law. With my utmost pleasure, I invite Dr. Rajesh Kumar Acharya before you to share his piece of wisdom.
Good morning, all of you.
Good morning.
I would like to start this seminar, which is a webinar, packaging and designing and branding. It is quite a novel subject. This markpatent.org is organizing webinars and seminars since last more than 15 years. It is to educate the people and mostly a business fraternity to develop its business and to understand the importance of intellectual properties to develop their business. Now, if you look at the Chinese products, their packaging and designing, it is really, really eye-catching. It helps them in develop their business very well. Even if you take a small pen, their packaging is really wonderful. And almost all the things, they are very good at packaging. We in India also, we are doing wonderful job. We are manufacturing a lot of things and rather very advanced level. But somewhere we are lacking in packaging and designing. Packaging and designing helps branding, and branding helps the business and continuous business rather. And when you are going for packaging and designing, then it is also required to be protected by intellectual property. When you do the packaging is also a subject matter of the trademark. If you design some new type of the packaging, protect it under the design law as well as under the trademark law. So nobody can copy your packaging. Moreover, the designing of the packaging rather, it is also very much of importance nowadays because design also can be protected under the sometime under the trademark law and also under the copyright law. Now today we have the chief guest, a very well-known personality, Mr. Devanshu Bhai today, and he is the chairman and managing director of Wadilal International, a truly international flavored company. And Wadilal is known for the designing innovative packaging, and there is a stamp, rather a branding. When you listen to Wadilal, even though it is a personal name, but when you listen the word Wadilal, it always comes to the Wadilal ice cream or Wadilal. They are in many, many items, and it comes to our mind immediately to see the Wadilal. So now, I think that we should start with the webinar. And at the onset, I would also like to welcome all the our organizers and audience. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Rajesh Bhai, for bringing me on this platform. And good morning to all of you. I'm happy to see that there are more than 50 participants in this webinar. It's a very important webinar for packaging, designing, and branding. And I want this, whatever I speak, I want this to be more interactive one. And I would request all of you to turn on your video. And if you want to ask any question, if you just please pause me.
Thank you so much, sir. It is under the guidance of Dr. Rajesh Kumar Acharya that HK Acharya & Company is now a team of highly qualified and expert visionaries. This session will have a series of panelists giving a remarkable approach in the subject matters of packaging, designing, and branding. Now, I would request our honorable chief guest, Mr. Devanshu Gandhi, being a chairman and a managing director at Wadilal International Private Limited. He has a demonstrated history of working in the food and beverages industry, which has skilled in food and beverage, dairy products, product development, food processing, and fastest moving consumer goods. He is a strong business development in a professional and a very well-known personality of Ahmedabad. I would now like to request sir to share his wisdom of thoughts with us.
Okay, fine. Sorry, I did.
It's okay.
Ketan Bhai. Can you just share the slides?
Yes, yeah, sir.
Sure.
Can you share the slides, Ketan Bhai?
He's just doing that. Mr. Rashmi is just doing that.
Well, good morning. Again, good morning, everyone. And I'm happy to see there are more than 50 participants in this webinar for packaging, designing, and branding. And I want this my speech to be more interactive one. And I would request all of you to turn on your video and pause me if you want to ask any questions, any doubts, please. Well, second slide. Wadilal started the second slide, slide two. Wadilal started its journey way back in 1907. We started making ice cream in Koti. Slide three. Our journey started in 1927. I think slide three I mentioned. Yeah. 1926. Our journey started with the Wadilal Soda Fountain Shop near Three Gate, which was started by our great-grandfather, Ranchurlal Gandhi. And still the shop is there. You can see the logo when we registered our logo in those days. This logo in 1950, we registered the old logo. Still it is there, Wadilal Soda Fountain. And today this shop is selling the highest ice cream in Gujarat. Slide four. In 1950, we started making cassata. We realized in those days that ice cream is not related to a couple of flavors like vanilla, strawberry, etc. But then we found that we let's give different colors and flavors into ice cream. We started making cassata, and that became instant hit in those days. Slide 4. Well, quickly, I'll go back to 1982 journey. Up to 82, we were limited to marketing and selling ice cream in Gujarat. We found that there is a need to go out of Gujarat. So we launched Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, and then we started entering into other states. And that was the journey to become a national brand. Next slide. In 87, we imported the first automatic candy line and cone line. We realized that there is a trend in the youngsters and the people to go out, hang around. And there was a trend to eat ice cream on the go. And what best if ice cream can be eaten with only one hand? So that's where the journey started. We entered into impulse category and reaching out to new audience in those days. Next slide. So in 1992, we entered into the international market. We started with making mango pulp, guava pulp, and different fruit pulps. And in 95, we entered into the state-of-the-art technology, individual quick freezing. And we were the first one to bring that technology in India. We started exporting our fruits and vegetables after freezing to US and other countries. And in 2000, we entered into ready-to-eat, ready-to-food, Indian cuisines, all types of Indian for the export market. And in those days, when we started exporting, we realized that Vadilal word was not properly pronounced in the foreign countries. So we decided that let's be it Vadilal, but let's give a suffix quick treat so it can be easily pronounced. Next slide. In 2000, we put up our largest ice cream factory in Pundra near Gandhinagar. That is the state of the art factory. We produce almost 3 lakh cones, 8 lakh candies, and half a ton of dry fruits every day. Next slide. So here the journey started to reach out to new audience, to reach out to new target groups. And we decided, let's come out with a consumer scheme. And this consumer scheme of Khao Khilao offer, which was offering one party pack and one party pack free, that becomes an instant hit. And later on, all the competitors had to follow this scheme. And that is still running, and people still remember that Vadilal started this scheme, and then later on what was followed by all the competitors. Next slide. In 2013, we were given the award by the Trust Research Advisory Council and Economic Times Brand Equity Survey, the most trusted ice cream brand of India. That was in 1913, 15, and 3 times we were awarded. Next slide. So in 2019, it was a journey to reach out to the consumers, more consumer, new audience, so we started selling ice cream online. We decided that let's have a tie-up with Zomato, Swiggy, in those days, like last year, they were not accepting ice cream because there were lot many logistic issues. We entered into tie-ups with them. We supported with all the infrastructure to online companies and started delivering ice cream at home. Today, we are selling almost 3% of our ice cream online. And we have our online services, which is doing very well. Next slide. Well, now here comes the packaging, design, and branding. I believe the biggest advantage of regenerating the brand through its look and feel is the best way to reach to the new customers, new target group. And in a country with the highest population with young blood, there is only one way to go, and that is packaging. We believe that first consumer eat ice cream by looking at by his eyes and then tongue. So packaging is very, very important. And the packaging has to be, packaging is proper, like proper packaging is not evolved overnight, but it is evolved over a period of time. And the way we have evolved the packaging, I'll explain you into the next slides. Next slide. Well, here is the logo. So I'll take you to 1972 when we started making ice cream on a commercial scale. So we started ice cream in Dudeshwar with 1 ton of ice cream, and we developed a logo, Vadilal. So in those days, this logo was designed by the NID team. In those days, we were operating only in Gujarat, initially in Ahmedabad, and from 75-76 we started expanding to Gujarat. And in 82-83 we realized that let's go to other states. We entered into other states, but somehow we found that in other states they were not pronouncing Vadilal properly because of the candy shape. And they were having very difficulty in pronouncing the brand. And once a brand can't be pronounced properly, it can't be a brand. So we decided that let's change the logo. So later we made a change in the font, shifted from a sharp look to the smoothness, created a strong palette to grab the attention. And then I tell you, in those days, what was happening, that there was a myth among the Indian consumers that ice cream contains gelatin. So we wanted to break that myth. In those days, there was no green dot, red dot, brown dot, things like things the way it is there. Government of India has announced. But we decided to use prefix as a pure vegetarian, and it became instant hit. So people were believing that Vadilal is only brand which gives a pure vegetarian ice cream, and that became instant hit, and that gave a lot of flip to our sales. So later on, government came out with the green vegetarian, like they announced that a vegetarian product has to be given a green dot. So we changed the logo, and then the new logo, which was like followed the trend of the compact logo, brand became almost brand was also synonymous with the ice cream. Later on, we found that let's remove all the boundaries. So why? Because brand was on expansion stage. we decided to enter into exports of ice cream. So we decided let's give a brand a different let's break the boundaries. So we decided that let's make the boundaries and go international. Let's go to the templates. Next slide. So the template here, it is also a journey, in fact, which started from 86, 87 up to 220. So in 86, 87, when we changed the logo, our logo was designed by the creative agency Ambience in Mumbai. So they gave the, along with the logo, they gave the template, which was made out of vibrant colors. And as I mentioned to you that people were eating only running flavors like vanilla, strawberry, pista, kesar, maybe butterscotch. So we decided let's show them that ice cream stands for colors, ice cream stands for flavors. And then the template was designed and on all our glow sign boards, on all our packaging, we started giving this template. And that was the trend, so which continued up to 2000. And in 2000, again, we changed the logo. From a bright color, we started using we removed the template and bright color was used. And in the third template, you can see that the template we made the red color a little bit subtle, shifted from a bright color to a little bit of elegant, subtle color, because there was a trend towards the pastel colors. And I want all of you just look at the third template, what it stands for. Can someone answer? But this, so this template stands for the tongue. And not only tongue, but it also it resembles to our original oval shape logo. And this logo helped us to design our packaging properly, bring the synergy in the packaging, which you can come to know in the next slides. Please shift to next slide. So packaging, this is when we started using the logo in 86, we started 1990, we started using the logo, which is oval shape. And oval shape, along with the sub brands, we introduced sub brands in 2008, which I will explain you in the next slides. You can see that even phase two, the colors are bright. Only the template part has changed. So what is the packaging? Packaging is to bring the wow factor in the mind of the consumer. As I mentioned that consumer eat any product, any food product by its eye and then by tongue. So if you give a proper packaging and if it stands out on the shelf differently than the others, then definitely consumer will pick that pack first. And that is, and make sure that packaging is also in a synergy with the other packaging. So in our packaging, we used a bright pack colors, loud product image, unique packaging, which stands out in the crowd. Please bring to the, please change the slide. So this is the third template and which is the current one which we are using? Tongue and old ship template and border lines in the Wadilal is broke, like taken out. This is pastel and subtle colors. This has no sharpness. It is this color has, if you go to any shelf space or if you go to any freezer, we made sure that the ink also we have used in such a way that the ice is not there is no iciness on the packaging. So it is the names as well as the flavors are coming out in the deep freezer very easily. Well, in 2008 we introduced sub-brands. We introduced sub-brands like Gourmet, Bada Bite, Flingo, Ice Super to reach out to the young hearts, to reach out to the new audience, and to reach out to the new target groups. It also helped us to bring the brand loyalty to our towards our brand. So the Flingo, which originates from the fling, that means a romantic relationship, and is especially used in the young generation. And it can introduced in our cone as a symbol of love. A Flingo can be even shared by two. We introduce flavors like chocolate, strawberry, butterscotch. So it is appreciated by the youth. Bada Bite. Hamara sabse bada bite. And Bada Bite broke the market. We introduced it as an evening snack, a large size bar to satisfy the tea time hunger. Gourmet, initially ice cream was considered as a mass segment, but slowly the trend towards eating super premium ice cream started. And we appealed to consumer that wanted an international quality and flavors, and which we offered into our Gourmet packaging. We were the first one to come out with the international quality and the black color packaging in the Gourmet. So we were the first one to introduce black color packaging in the entire food category, not in only in ice cream. Next slide. So next slide, please. So Gourmet, you can see the black packaging, how it is evolved. So the logo, which started somewhere in 2000 and then 2013 and the latest one. So how the black color packaging, it's a unique pack, black pack, innovative flavors, and it's a kind of a premium positioning and to stand out among the other competitors. In Ice Troopers, that is for the kids category. So to target a kids, and this sub-brand also helped us to advertise on different channels, because channels are also being viewed by different genre, by different target group, by the audience. So the brand mascot which we like developed for the Ice Trooper, which helped us very well. It builds a strong brand identity, reinforces the top of the mind awareness, and it becomes instant hit among the children. Next slide. So, well, in 2015, we realized that to uplift our brand, and to uplift our brand image into the North market, we must have a tie-up with the celebrity. We did a research by the Nielsen, and we found that this celebrity, being from Haryana, Ambala, has a lot of mileage in that area. And we wanted to get consumer attention towards the brand. So we decided to have a celebrity tie-up with Parniti Chopra for 4 years. And she helped us to boost our brand image on the social media, especially in the North. And it has helped us to give us mileage in states like Delhi, Haryana, UP. And she was basically from the North market, and a lot of we found that the movies of Parniti Chopra has the high were viewed more in the North as compared to western part. That was the research report. Next slide. Well, now the topic of branding imitation. Today, I feel Vadilal has been a trendsetter in multiple areas, and from its logo, in its ad, and its flavorful ice creams. And many local brand, many even national brands have tried to copy, like black packaging we introduced in 2008. Later on, it was followed by all our competitors. Sub-brands, as I mentioned to you, still our sub-brands are being copied not only in ice cream, but other categories like juices and snacks and etc. Even Vadilal brand is also imitated by the snack categories, and we take our utmost precautions to see that our brand is protected with the help of our law attorneys, and we take steps at appropriate time quickly. And with this, I end my speech, and I hand over this to Ketan Bhatt. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. We are honored by your esteemed presence here, and we thank you for sparing a valuable time for us. Now, our next panelist, Mr. Ketan Bhatt, he is a trademark attorney and heads the trademark division of our firm with his expertise and experience. He holds a master's degree in law in specializations with IPR and also a bachelor's degree in commerce from Gujarat University. He is also the member of Bar Council of Gujarat. I now request Mr. Ketan Bhatt to enlighten all of us with the topic of branding as a tool for the business development.
Hey, thank you, Jalashree, for the nice introduction. First of all, I'd like to thank my senior, Dr. Rajesh Kumar Acharya, you know, proprietor of HK Acharya and Company and Managing Trustee of MarkBetter.org. And thank you for giving me this opportunity and sharing the screen with you in this webinar. Okay, so let's quickly move to my topic. Actually, my topic is actually branding a tool for business development. But I make it in such a way that branding a strong tool for marketing and business development. Actually, as I think Devan Shubhai has already, you know, share their success story, you know, how they manage the brand, the sub-brands, and how they used to, you know, go for marketing and all, and how they used to target the different people, like, you know, the child's adults and all. So you know, I have very, you know, less things to introduce now, but let me quickly just go through means how the branding is, you know, helpful for marketing and then by virtue of marketing for the business development. So actually, you know, it's very difficult to, you know, pronounce, you know, inform, you know, tell you the technical definition of a trademark. So I just, you know, try to give you the definition of trademark by example. So this is the packaging. This is, you know, a designing of, you know, the brand of soap. I just removed the branding part of it. So without branding, it's very difficult, you know, because even I think Dhaval Bhai and Tejas Bhai also will be, you know, convinced that without branding, it's very difficult to, you know, design packaging and all. So the trademark means, you know, the brand capable of distinguishing the goods and services of one to those of another. So whenever you go to any shop or anywhere, means, you know, you have to pronounce the name of brand. You cannot say that I need any soap or yeah, you just give me any brand rice or something like that. You actually need to pronounce the name of brand. So this is the name of brand, Lux. So now let's go through with the definition, technical definition of the trademark. The trademark means a mark capable of being represented graphically. So represented graphically, we have the, you know, quick roles of designing and packaging and all, and which is capable of distinguishing the goods or services of one person from those of another. And that is the only reason why you need to pronounce your brand, whether it is on a social media, on a radio or on television. You need to pronounce the name of brand. So these all things can include it in the trademark application, like company name, trading style, just like a Wadilal. Wadilal is a trade name and trading style. Then brand name, Gourmet, Ice Super, these are all the brands. Shape of goods, the shape of the packaging, as Devanshu Bhai gave us the perfect example. Then domain, then sound mark, packaging material, again, we have the packaging there, heading, tickets, name, signature, these all, or the combination of these all can be registered. So now I'm just moving to the technical aspect, to the marketing aspects. Now, during the 90s, before we have the, you know, modernization policies and all introduced by our, you know, late Prime Minister, our former Prime Minister, this was the Indian market, right? You know, people have to touch the actual product. You know, people, previously they were very smart enough, you know, they can touch the actual product and they can see the quality of the product. Like my generation people, you know, I cannot recognize whether this is a good rice or this is a good grain or this is a good wheat or something like that. Because I can just pronounce the name of good brands. I cannot, you know, see that I check the product, whether it's a good product or bad product. So this was the market in the 90s. Now, this is the current trend. Now, you have, whenever you go to any mall, any provision store or something like that, you just have to pronounce the name of brand. And they will going to give you that brand. You will use that brand. If the brand was good, then you will remember that name of brand. And whenever you go again to the markets, you will ask for the same brand. So this was the market. And now the current trend. Well, in the school days, in college, even I think today also, humko teen different tenses padhaye jaate the, like past tense, future tense, and, you know, present tense and all. Now we have another tense like corona. People used to call this a corona kal, right? And I think during demonetization and all also, people used to, you know, this now different apps like Paytm, PhonePe and all. Like demonetization ke time pe kisi ke paas, you know, physical money, they don't have it. So that they tried, you know, started to use Paytm, PhonePe and all. The same thing is also like people cannot go outside. They cannot, you know, actually touch the product. They cannot go to the provision store. They cannot go to the shopping market and all. So now they have started to buy the products in big basket from different Geo Smart and all. Like Abhi, means if you see in the past, after even demonetization, people used to go with the Paytm and all. They don't want to, you know, stand in the queues for paying electricity bills, you know, gas bills or any other things. Even they have the hard cash now, but they don't want to go there. So after even this corona trend goes, I guess people will go into, you know, follow the same strategy that I will going to buy the product with the big basket, the GeoSmart and all. I don't want to go in the market. I can save that time and all. So, but for that particular thing, now it's the responsibility of the manufacturer that they have to reach to the customer. Devanshu bhai rightly said that in the last year, they've also, you know, it's very difficult for ice cream actually, you know, okay, aap usko order lenge and then whenever the logistics wala issue hai, it's very difficult. In fact, it might happen that kabhi wo melt ho jayega. So even if the ice cream people, if you know, starting to do that, now it's the responsibility of manufacturer and other traders also. They have to reach to the customer now. In the 90s, the segment was like that, ki bhai, just open the shop, just open the factory. You will receive the order. People will come to your shop and factory and they will going to give you the orders. But this is not the case right now. You have to reach to the customer now, and to reach out to the customer, your branding, your packaging and your design plays the vital role. Like, of course, in other segments also, means we used to have a physical seminar, as my senior says that hum log pichle 15 saal se matlab physical seminars kar rahe the, but after this corona we have, you know, matlab done the bunch, you know, bunch of the different seminars once in a week. So we use now Meet, this Microsoft Meet, then Zoom, and Google, this Google Meet and Google Team seminar platform, you know, do the webinars. Even, you know, for the reading also, the people used to now use Kindle and all. So this is the current trend. Now let's see, once over the time, how the concept of packaging, branding and designing changes. Like in 90s and 80s, you know, people won't, you know, namkeen wagera, people matlab bahar ka koi khata hi nahi tha, breads and all. And IT products jo hai, matlab I think after 90s and 2000, use hona shuru hua, the new invention, the new products launched in last 20 years and all. Like, you know, the examples are the Xerox, Fivestick, Walkman, Astral pipes and all. Now, as Devanshu ji mentioned that they want to target the different age people with the different brands. Like Gourmet is for rich people, like premium product, like Bada Bite is for the child, children and all, and Family Pack is for the family and all. The same way, Tata has also launched the same, you know, follow the same strategy. Like Titan is, you know, premium brand. Timex is for the kids. Sonata is also, you know, the medium range of brand they're having. So they also go with the same strategy as far as the marketing is concerned. So whenever the Diwali and all come, you will see the Amir Khan when, you know, branding and promoting Titan brands. I hope you have seen those ads as well. Whenever the school open time is something like that, they will going to promote the Timex brand. And Sonata is, you know, they used to promote it every time, every year. Now, how you can, you know, strategies, you know, you can find that you give the strategy for a new invention for the new brand. Like आप लोगों ने स्टैटिस्टिक का वो पुराना एड देखा होगा कि पहले वो लोग जो है गम का किस तरह यूज करते थे, राइट? उसका एक बहुत फेमस एड भी आया था, चिप चिप वाला जो भी था वो. सो नाउ व्हाट दे हैव डन इज स्टैटिस्टिक, मतलब यू डोंट नीड टू, यू नो, आपको आपका हाथ खराब करने की जरूरत नहीं है. सो दे कम अप विद द न्यू ब्रांड, इट्स कॉल्ड फेविस्टिक, लॉन्च बाय पेडीलाइट एंड ऑल, मतलब फेविकॉल इज फेमस फॉर. सो ही यूज द वर्ड फेवी एंड देन स्टिक बिकॉज इट इज अ स्टिक, इट्स अ ग्लू स्टिक. So they coined the mark with Fevistick. Now they marketed this brand in such a way that iska technical naam kisi ko pata bhi nahi. Like even though you will ask for Fevistick, wo aapko aur koi dekhe na de, but you recognize this product only as Fevistick. Iska technical naam hai glue stick, but no one actually pronounced that I need a glue stick. They always say that I need Fevistick. And by virtue of this, you know, strong marketing and all, people only recognize this brand and they only ask for this brand. So this is how, if you have a good branding, you have a good marketing strategy and good packaging, you can definitely claim the monopoly of the brand. Walkman. Well, in the 90s, we all know that Michael Jackson's, you know, music was on a peak. In Florida, people used to, you know, have their stereo system on their shoulder. And they used to say, you know, hear the song. वो खुद तो सुनते ही थे, लोगों को भी सुनाते थे, right? It's very difficult to carry such a, you know, big stereo system and all. So the Sony came up with a new invention, as a workman. Of course, they may have protected under for the patents and design and all. But they have marketed this product in such a way that लोग फिलिप्स के स्टोर पे जाके बोलते थे मुझे वॉकमैन चाहिए. इसका भी टेक्निकल नाम मुझे तो आज तक पता नहीं चला है. Of course, it's a complex stereo system, but we only recognize this product as Walkman. Same Vaseline also cream के लिए mention. People used to pronounce it Vaseline. Of course, in the same they have also suffering from duplicate here and all, but they used to take a good legal actions against all the infringers. Astral pipes. This is also another example. No one ever feel or think that कि भाई पाइप के ऊपर भी कोई ब्रांडिंग करेगा. No one ever think that before. So what they have done, they have changed the color of the pipe. They put it in the white now, and they put their branding over the pipes. And just like, you know, Devanshu ji has, you know, used this mix stars from Bollywood to promote the brand. Same way also they have choose Salman Khan to promote the brand, and we all know the results of that. Now, designing and packaging. Why? It is absolutely essential. Of course, you know, Tejas ji and Dhaval bhai will definitely going to मतलब उसके ऊपर ज्यादा फोकस करेंगे. बट आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल. और ये एक ऐसा ब्रांड, ये कंफ्यूजन था जो मतलब व्हेन आई वाज इन स्कूल, मतलब मुझे भी कंफ्यूजन हुआ था, आप लोगों को भी हुआ होगा. पैराशूट, दे हैव द ब्लू एंड ग्रीन मतलब पैकेजिंग, और ऐसा ही सिमिलर जो है एक पैकेजिंग आता था उसके ऊपर ब्रांड के ऊपर कोकोनट लिखा हुआ होता था, एंड पीपल यूज टू कंफ्यूज. वो ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर लगता था. सो आप जब उसको यूज करेंगे ऑयल, उसका स्मेल अलग आएगा या उसका रिजल्ट अलग आएगा, देन यू विल कम टू नो कि भाई दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली डिफरेंट, मतलब डुप्लीकेट ब्रांड है. सो कंफ्यूजन, द आई ऑफ द कस्टमर इज इंपॉर्टेंट. नाउ दिस इज अ ब्रांड सब ब्रांड ट्रेडर्स एंड पैकेजिंग. आई एक्चुअली मोर यू नो मतलब फोकस मोर ऑन फूड इंडस्ट्रीज एंड ऑल. सो हाउ टू यू नो चूज ब्रांड, मतलब एज फार एज ब्रांडिंग इज कंसर्न, एंड हाउ टू चूज द पैकेजिंग एंड डिजाइनिंग ऑफ द ब्रांड. प्रीवियसली इन 90s एंड 2000 लोग जो है ब्रांड तो सेम रखते थे, बट उसका पैकेजिंग जो है वो डिफरेंट रखते थे. ये जो मैंने सिंबल कंफ्यूजन वाला रखा है ना, वो इसीलिए रखा है बिकॉज यदि आप कोई भी ब्रांड का प्रोडक्ट लेने जाओ तो यदि वो ये मतलब फूड का हो या कुछ भी हो, दे यूज टू चेंज द कलर कॉम्बिनेशन एंड पैकेजिंग. जैसे सम्राट का यदि कोई एग्जाम्पल है, ऑफकोर्स सम्राट ने जो भी पैकेजिंग वगैरह किया इज एब्सोल्युटली ब्रिलियंट. इवन उसका अपर पोर्शन जो है, मतलब ब्रांड का जो पैकेजिंग का अपर पोर्शन इज द सेम सेम कलर कॉम्बिनेशन एंड ऑल, और नीचे उसने जो प्रोडक्ट का फोटो है वो रखा है. बट प्रीवियसली क्या होता था कि ब्रांड का नेम या फोटो सेम रहता था, बाकी पूरा पैकेजिंग डिफरेंट रहता था. बट नाउडेज इफ यू सी लेज, बालाजी, सम्राट, दे ऑल, मतलब वो लोग जो है उसका पूरा ब्रांड का जो पैकेजिंग का स्ट्रक्चर है वो सेम रखते हैं. दे यूज टू कीप इट एज द सेम, एंड दे जस्ट चेंज द कलर कॉम्बिनेशन, या फिर उसके नीचे उसका सब ब्रांड जो है वो चेंज कर देते हैं. Just like Lay's them, मतलब उसका different different जो wafers का flavors आता है, just they just change the colors. Like onions के लिए green है, tomato के लिए red है. But overall, you will never confuse कि भई ये original Lay's का product है या नहीं. In the same way, if you have different segments and different varieties, always try to have a similar structure of packaging because eye of the customer is important. उनको ऐसा एक बार भी लगा कि यार ये अलग है, ये अलग है. Packaging is also look different. Fonts are also look different. There are chances ki bhi isme kuch duplication ho raha hai. So better, I should avoid that brand. Aise situation, matlab, nahi hona chahiye. Consumer ko ekdam, matlab, satisfaction ya guarantee hona chahiye ki bhi ye product mein koi duplicate nahi kar raha hai. And we can definitely going to buy this product without any hesitation. So it is also the responsibility of the manufacturer and trader. Now, why applications, you know, trademark application and registration is necessary. As I said, that now people go online to sell their product. Now, each and everyone, you know, they used to sell the product on Amazon, Flipkart and all. Now, Amazon also has their own brand registry. So, if you want to sell your product in Amazon, you have to go for a brand registry. You need to mention your application number. You need to, send in the copy of registration certificate. Then and then only they will allow you to sell your product in the Amazon. Same way Flipkart also have the same. Even if someone is misusing your brand in the Amazon, you need to raise the complaint in Amazon that this is the duplicate of my brand, this is my registration certificate, and Amazon will going to remove that brand from the Amazon. So for these particular thing, the application is absolutely necessary. One other thing, there are two different aspects for filing the trademark application. The first aspect is that to know the other people that this is your brand. Let's hope that 90% people in India, they are genuine. And just like other people, they will going to search the availability of the trademark. Like if I want to, you know, go with Vadilal, of course I will not go Devanshu Bhai. But if I want to, you know, launch the product under the name of Vadilal, so I will definitely going to make the search of the Vadilal in particular class, whichever class you fall in for food industries and all. So if I feel that Vadilal is already registered, then of course I will not going to, you know, going to adopt that particular brand, because in the initial stage of my business, of course I don't want any litigation. So that is the first step to, you know, first main reason to filing the trademark application, and other reason to prevent the infringed party ke bhi jo aapka trademark ka misuse karte hain. Then as far as trademark is concerned, why absolutely essential first to file, first to use? As far as India is concerned, India, you know, they give the priority to first to use. Now, whichever actually uses the first brand mark first in the market, he will going to be the owner of the particular trademark application. But if you see in other countries, if you want to export your product in other countries, they used to give the preference to first to file, not first to first to use. So it is always advisable to, you know, file the trademark application to protect your trademark application first in India and then later on in the respective countries. Like trademark protection gives you the territorial right. World trademark मतलब ऐसा कोई कुछ protection नहीं है. You need to file a separate application in separate countries, or in case of Madrid system, you need to give the separate designation should be there.
Good.
Export product without the brand. In few companies also, they used to, you know, export the brand without any brand. They just like they used to do work like just a job work and all. So that trade name is your trademark. Of course, if anyone wants to search their name, they will going to Google their name, and they will going to see you by your website and all. So you need to be careful that kabhi aapke jaisa similar naam ke sath koi company open na kare ya koi yadi karta hai ya website open karta hai, then you need to take the immediate action. Always prepare the distribution agreement with the distributor, whether for India or abroad. Matlab always prepare and draft the distribution agreement. And protection least developed countries, of course, in the initial of your business stage, you cannot take the competition with the US, Europe, and another, you know, major big countries. You can start, you know, to develop the market in the lower, you know, least developed country, and then you can slightly you can go ahead. Enforcement protection of the trademark. Now, as Devanshuji said that if anyone infringes your trademark, you need to take the action immediately. Because registration certificate मतलब जो है, it doesn't mean that कि भाई आपके पास registration certificate आ गया तो people लोगों को पता चल जाएगा, and they will be going to misuse their brand. In Gujarati we have a very good thought that the कायदो ए जागरूक मानसों matters. Like, you know, if you are aware and if you take the action, it's good for you. Because I just give you the very, you know, brief example that if I just as I said that कि यदि मैं वाडीलाल brand use कर रहा हूँ nowadays, या फिर कोई और brand, of course I cannot compete with the वाडीलाल XYZ brand I'm using now, and it is already मतलब XYZ brand already किसी का registered है from last 15 to 20 years, and I have just started to make use of the brand, and the registered proprietor है मतलब they just come to know and they give me the notice. On a very within a 15 days or 20 days of the opening of my office or my factory, I received the notice from the registered proprietor. So my initial reaction will be that, कि भाई अभी business start भी नहीं हुआ है, अभी marketing भी नहीं हुआ है, कुछ भी branding वाले कुछ भी नहीं हुआ, and I am receiving this notice. So what I'm going to do is, I will just going to ask for a few days time. Maybe of course I will going to change the name of my brand, and of course I will not going to infringe your brand. Now. मतलब रजिस्टर्ड प्रोप्राइटर ने मुझे कुछ नोटिस नहीं दिया, पांच छह साल हो गए, दस साल हो गए. नाउ आई एम हैविंग अ गुड अर्निंग विद द ब्रांड, मे बी मोर देन 10 करोड़, 20 करोड़, 50 करोड़. सो आफ्टर 5 और 10 इयर्स, इफ ही विल गोइंग टू गिव मी द नोटिस दैट ओके दिस इज माय ब्रांड एंड ऑल, ऑफ कोर्स नॉट एट ऑल आई विल नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज माय ब्रांड, बिकॉज आई एम अर्निंग यू नो हैंडसम अमाउंट विद दैट ब्रांड. सो आई विल डेफिनेटली चैलेंज, आई विल डेफिनेटली गो फॉर अ फर्दर लिटिगेशंस इन द सिटिजनशिप कोर्ट और हाई कोर्ट और एनी अदर, बट I will never going to change the brand, and I will give more competition. So it is always advisable to take the this litigation actions and all immediately, as I it's very difficult to stop infringement after giving too much time. Filing application at advanced stage is always advisable to stop the genuine people to adopt the identical or similar trademark, as I said. And one more thing I need to tell you, that the ignorance of law is not justification of law. So whenever you want to adopt a new brand, always search the particular brand in the trademark registry's website as well as in the market. Because you cannot say, Vince, whenever you know someone files a suit against you, you cannot say that I wasn't know that this is your registered brand. It is your responsibility to check that. Like आप किसी का मर्डर कर दो और फिर बोल दो कि यार मुझे नहीं पता था मर्डर करना तो क्राइम इज जस्ट लाइक दैट यू शुड नो दैट इग्नोरेंस ऑफ लॉ इज नॉट द जस्टिफिकेशन ऑफ लॉ देन टेरिटोरियल राइट्स एज आई सेड ग्लोबल यूनिवर्सल ट्रेडमार्क पीपल यूज्ड टू से दैट आई मींस आई हैव रजिस्टर्ड माय ट्रेडमार्क ग्लोबली और इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट यू नीड टू फाइल एप्लीकेशन इन इंडिया एंड अदर सेपरेट कंट्रीज वेल आफ्टर मेक इन इंडिया कंप्लेन ऑफकोर्स मोर एंड मोर पीपल यूज्ड टू यू नो गिव द मतलब एक्सपोर्ट वगैरह मतलब बहुत ज्यादा कर रहे हैं सो Whenever you actually, you know, export your product, whenever you appoint the distribution in other countries, always prepare the distribution agreement and just make the IP clause very specifically that, okay, bhai, iska IP ka jo bhi trademark, copyright design, whatever the protections are, matlab jo hai, jo ownership hai, is, belongs to yours. And must file the respective countries before hiring the distribution. So with this end, I just want to end my presentation and I would love to give the answer if any questions you have. Or you can also give me, you know, mail on my email ID that is info@skindia.com, even if you have any questions later on. Thank you for hearing me patiently. Over to you, Jalashree.
Thank you, Mr. Bird, for such a fruitful presentation. I request all the participants to drop their query and question in the chat box and our panelist will answer it at the end of session. Our next panelist, Mr. Dhawal M. Jhaveri, who have maintained position as a leader paper packaging provider in Ahmedabad, Gujarat, with this vision to spend his business. He is an expert visionary with a deep knowledge in printing and packaging industry. He is a guiding force in domestic and international marketing. He is an able leader who set a benchmark to all his colleagues and employees. Sri Vallabh Printers Packaging Private Limited work on a true customer partnership by delivering quality products and timely services and strictly adhere to their ethical business standards and not at all compromising with his quality. It is a renowned name in the paper packaging industry and more than 22 years of expertise in private printing and packaging industry, Sri Vallabh Printers Private Limited is a one-stop paper packaging solution. I now request Mr. Dhawal M. Jhaveri to enlighten us with the topic of packaging as a tool for the business development. Sir, kindly unmute your audio.
Good afternoon. Thanks, Jalashree, for giving my introduction. I thank to Mark Patton team and especially Dr. Rajesh Acharya for giving me opportunity to share my views on business development through packaging. And greetings to all the dignitaries of webinar, Devanshu Bhai and Tejas Bhai. Maro vishay che packaging thi business growth thai shake. I will talk in Gujarati and in a very simple language. Ele badana kada samjhan pade ritna. Packaging shu je, pehli to vastu ye je ke packaging shu je. Suppose we are going on the street and ત્યાં આગળ આપણે સિંગ વાળો ઊભો હોય છે આપણે સિંગ વાળાના પાસેથી 10 રૂપિયા ની સિંગ લઈએ છે 10 રૂપિયા ની સિંગ લઈએ છે અને આપણે એ ઘરે લઈ જવી છે તો we ask him to pack in the paper so that is also one type of pack એ જ વસ્તુ તમને નાના પાઉચીસ માં પ્લાસ્ટિક કે ફોઇલ પાઉચીસ માં મળવાનું ચાલુ થયું છે that cost 15 રૂપિયા or 20 રૂપિયા અને other than that now it is available in also paper tins and પેલા આપણે પતરાના ટીન માં ભી મળે છે that cost nearly 35 રૂપિયા the same product the sink vastu andar ek j sink che ane it is availability in three packaging એટલે ત્રણે type na packaging ma apna available thai che hu aa topic apna example nu pachhad ani upar leish apne have actually jyare apne atyana time ma shu che ke product jyare launch kariye che ne to khali apne char p upar concentrate kariye che that is product promotion price and place apne ek vastu neglect kariye che that is the fifth p that is packaging atyana time ma apne jyare aa badu cost set karta hoy ne badu set thai jaye mast ane paji apne chelle packaging ma apne chelle nahi vat ke apne price gani we will set it out and that is wrong but now aa corona no kaal gayo e darmiyan apne joyu ke this is in this digital world ke loko have packaging ne jove che karan ke atyare tame online purchasing karo cho you are not seeing the product but you are seeing the packaging any vastu box jo jo anu packaging jo jo when it looks nice then you just click bhai humne aa mukli aapo so our online ના જમાનામાં વી શુડ ટાર્ગેટ અવર પેકેજિંગ વેરી વેલ. આપણે એક વસ્તુ કહી શકીએ ને કે આપણે જાણે કુવાના દેડકામાં જે હોય છે ને, ધેર થિંકિંગ ઇઝ ઇનસાઇડ ધ વેલ ઓનલી. એ લોકો બહારનું વિચારતા નથી, પણ યુ સી બહુ જ પેકેજિંગ જગત એટલું બધું વિશાળ છે. વી હેવ લોટ ઓફ વેરાયટીઝ આઉટ ઓફ ધ વર્લ્ડ. એન્ડ ઇફ યુ વોન્ટ ટુ વર્ક ઓન ઇન્ટરનેશનલી, તમે ઇન્ટરનેશનલી વર્કઆઉટ કરવું હશે તો તમારે પેકેજિંગમાં સુધારા લાવવા જ પડશે. આઈ થેન્ક્સ ટુ દેવાંશુભાઈ, એમને ઘણા બધા ચેન્જીસ છે, હું એમને બી વાત કરીશ હમણાં. સેકન્ડ થિંગ, આપણે કોઈ બી આપણી પ્રોડક્ટ છે એને આપણે કપડાં પહેરાઈએ છીએ, સો ઇટ ઇઝ વન ટાઈપ ઓફ ડ્રેસિંગ. એટલે આપણે કપડાં પ્રોપર પહેરેલા હોય તો ઇટ લુક્સ યુનિક. એટલે સપોઝ આપણે એક એક્ઝામ્પલ, હું બધા એક્ઝામ્પલ સાથે જ કહીશ તમને. સપોઝ આપણે લગ્નમાં જઈએ છીએ, ઇફ સમબડી ઇઝ વેરિંગ યુનિક ડ્રેસીસ અને સમબડી ઇઝ વેરિંગ રેગ્યુલર ડ્રેસીસ, તો અવર આઈ કેચિંગ ઇઝ ઓવર દેટ યુનિક ડ્રેસીસ. વાવ, સુપર પહેર્યું છે. સો દેટ ઇઝ પેકેજિંગ. તમે સમજો કોઈ બી વસ્તુને ઢાંકો છો, કોઈને ડ્રેસિંગ કરાવો છો, ધેન ઇટ ઇઝ અ યુનિક વે, દેટ ઇઝ રિયલ ધ પેકેજિંગ. એ તમે આઈ કેચિંગ કરવું જોઈએ. હવે પેકેજિંગ શેના માટે? હવે આપણે જો સપોઝ પેલી સિંગ બી લીધી, એ બી ખાવાની છે, પાઉચવાળી બી સિંગ છે એ બી ખાવાની છે, અને જે ડબ્બામાં છે એ બી આપણે ખાવાની છે. તો ફાયદો શું? તો આપણે અત્યારની એકચ્યુઅલ પોઝિશનમાં સપોઝ આપણે સિંગ જે પેકેટમાં કાગળમાં લઈને ઘરે જઈએ છીએ ઇન ધીસ રેની સિઝન ઓર એની કોઈ બી સિઝનમાં, ઇટ વિલ બી ત્યાં સુધી ઘરે જતા સુધીમાં જે હવાઈ જશે કે એની જે સેલ્ફ લાઈફ છે એ પૂરી થઈ જાય છે. આ પેકિંગની કારણ શું છે? કે ઇટ એન્ટેક્સ યોર સેલ્ફ લાઈફ. એની જે એની જે લાઈફ છે એ વધારવા માટે આપણે પેકિંગની જરૂર છે. બાકી તો કાગળમાં બી તમે લઈને જાઓ અને ઘરે જતા સુધીમાં હવાઈ જાય છે, ઇટ ઇઝ યુઝલેસ. જો 10 રૂપિયા આપણે વેસ્ટ જાય છે, રેધર દેન વી શુડ ગો ઇન અ પ્રોપર પેકિંગ. જેમ કે આપણે સમ્રાટના જોયા, તમે સમ્રાટમાં ઘણું બધું અમને આપણે ડિસ્કસ કર્યું કેતનભાઈએ. હવે પેકેજિંગ માં કેટલી બધી વેરાયટીઝ છે. હું આપણા નાની નાની વસ્તુ પેકિંગની વાત કરી. હવે સપોઝ કુરુગેટેડ બોક્સિસ છે. હવે કોઈ બી ગ્લાસ બોટલ કે પેટ બોટલ કોઈ બી ટ્રાન્સપોર્ટેશનમાં તમારે નાખવું હોય, ધ પેકેજિંગ ઇઝ મસ્ટ. યુ શુડ હેવ ટુ યુઝ મોનો કાર્ટન, સીપર કાર્ટન ઓર આઉટર કાર્ટન્સ, નહીતર તમારી વસ્તુ પ્રોપરલી પહોંચી શકતી નથી. હવે સપોઝ આપણે એક્સપોર્ટ કરવું હોય, જો પેકેજિંગ પ્રોપર ના, ઇફ યુ આર ડુઈંગ એન એક્સલન્ટ વર્ક, આપણે આઈસ્ક્રીમ હોય કે કોઈ બી વસ્તુ જો એનું ડીપ ફ્રોઝર વાળું બોક્સિસ ના બનાવીએ કે પ્રોપર બોક્સિસ ના બનાવીએ, સો ઇટ વિલ યોર પ્રોડક્ટ વોન્ટ રીચ ટુ ધ કસ્ટમર ઓર ધ રિટેલ કાઉન્ટર્સ, ત્યાં સુધીમાં તમારું સ્પોઇલ થઈ જાય છે. સો એટલે દરેક પેકેજિંગ ટ્રાન્સપોર્ટેશન લોંગ ટર્મ માટે ખૂબ જરૂરી છે. હવે બ્રાન્ડિંગ માટે આપણે વાત કરી, તો આપણું પેકેજિંગ બ્રાન્ડિંગ અને કોમ્યુનિકેશન બંને માટે બહુ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ છે. બ્રાન્ડિંગ એટલે શું? હવે આપણે જેમ વાડીલાલનો લોગો છે, એમને શું કીધું કે એમને બોર્ડર કાઢી નાખી ઇન્ટરનેશનલ લેવલ. એમનો કોન્સેપ્ટ જુઓ તમે, કે એમને બોર્ડર કાઢી નાખી ઇન્ટરનેશનલ વર્ક માટે, કે દે આર ફ્રી ઓફ બોર્ડર્સ, કોઈ એમને કોઈ બોર્ડર જ નથી, દે કેન વર્ક આઉટ એની વેર. ઇન ધ સેમ વે તમે એપલના કોઈ બી પ્રોડક્ટ છે એના આઉટર પેકેજિંગ તમે જોશો, ઇટ ઇઝ અ વેરી યુનિક વે. તમે દૂર પડ્યું હોય ને તો બી તમે એમ કહી શકો, વાવ આ એપલનું જ છે. સો એ ટાઈપના પેકેજિંગ ડિઝાઇન કરે છે એ લોકો, એના ઉપરથી એમનું ઓટોમેટિક બ્રાન્ડિંગ થાય છે. ઇન ધ સેમ વે ટિમ્ફની એન્ડ કંપની, એ બી કેવી છે કે જેના બોક્સના પેકિંગ ઉપરથી તમે હાઈલાઇટ કરી શકો. અને એક આપણું ઇન્ડિયન તો છે જ, કોઈ નાના છોકરાઓને બી આંખ બંધ કરીને કહો ને ભાઈ આપણે લાલ કલરની ટૂથપેસ્ટ છે, એટલે તરત આંખ બંધ કરીને કહેશે હા પેલું લાલ કલરનું મોટું બોક્સ, એની પર કોલગેટ લખેલું છે. સો ધીસ ઇઝ ધ બ્રાન્ડિંગ. કોલગેટ આ રીતે હાઈલાઇટ થાય છે ડ્યુ ટુ ધીસ પેકેજિંગ. કારણ કે તમે પેકેજિંગ આમ રેપર વેપર કરીને આપતા હોય, ધીસ મેક્સ નો ડિફરન્સ ટુ યુ. એક બીજો એક એક્ઝામ્પલ આપીશ, આપણે મિલર કુપર કરીને બિયર મેન્યુફેક્ચરિંગ કંપની છે. હવે એ બિયર બનાવતી જયારે એને સ્ટાર્ટ કર્યું ને, ત્યારે વોટ હેપન કે બિયર વોઝ વેરી ગુડ, ટેસ્ટ વોઝ વેરી ગુડ, ઇટ વોઝ ગોઈંગ ઓન અ વેરી ગુડ ટ્રેક, પણ જે એમનું સેલ, એમનો જે ટાર્ગેટ હતો ને, દેટ વોઝ નોટ અચીવ. દે વેર કમિંગ ઇન ધ બોટલ્સ, જે કાચની બોટલ છે, અને બીજા એક બે પેકિંગમાં જતા હતા, બટ દેટ વોઝ નો, એમનો જે ગ્રોથ, એમનો જે ટાર્ગેટ હતો એ નહોતો અચીવ થઈ શકતો. સો આફ્ટર અ લોંગ મીટિંગ દે હેવ પ્લાન્ડ એન્ડ દે હેવ કન્વર્ટેડ ધેમસેલ્વ ઇન ટુ કેનિસ્ટર્સ, જે કેન્સમાં આવી ગયા, એન્ડ ધેન આફ્ટર ધેટ ગ્રોથ હેઝ ગોન વેરી હાઈ, એન્ડ એમની બેલેન્સ શીટ ખૂબ સરસ રીતે આગળ જતી રહી. હજી એક એક્ઝામ્પલ આપીશ કે દરેક સારું પેકેજિંગ જ ફ્રુટફુલ હોય એવું બી નથી. હવે ઘણી વાર પુઅર પેકેજિંગ બી બેનિફિશિયરી થઈ શકે છે. ઓસ્ટ્રેલિયન ગવર્મેન્ટે ટાર્ગેટ કર્યો હતો કે આપણા ઓસ્ટ્રેલિયામાં સિગરેટ ખૂબ પીવાય છે, સો હાઉ કુડ વી બેન કારણ કે કોઈની ઉપર તમે રિસ્ટ્રિક્ટ કરો ને તો ચોરી છુપે પીવાય જેમ કે આપણે ઇન્ડિયામાં પીવાય છે આપણે ના પાડીએ છતાં બી પીવાય જ છે સો વોટ શુડ હી દે ડુ દે હેવ ટાર્ગેટેડ ધ સિગરેટ કંપનીઝ અને એ લોકોને બધાને બોલાવીને એક મિટિંગ કરી કે તમે તમારી સિગરેટ કોઈ બ્રાન્ડથી નહીં વેચો ઇટ શુડ બી ઇન અ પ્લેન બોક્સ આમ સાદું બોક્સ હોય ને જેની અંદર તમારે સિગરેટ પેક કરીને આપવાની છે યોર પ્રોડક્શન વિલ બી ગોઈંગ ઓન બટ ઇટ શુડ નોટ બી અ બ્રાન્ડેડ એટલે બ્રાન્ડ આપણે નહીં કરીએ વોટ ધ રિઝલ્ટ પબ્લિક સિગરેટ પીતી હતી પણ ધીમે ધીમે જે યંગસ્ટર્સ છે જેના લુકના હિસાબે યાર કે આપણે હું રોથમન્સ પીવું છું ને ધીસ પીવું છું ને દે હેવ સ્ટાર્ટેડ ડિક્લાઇનિંગ એટલે ધીમે ધીમે સિગરેટ પીવાનો વર્ગ ઘટવા માંડ્યો સો પુઅર પેકેજિંગ બી ઘણી વાર બહુ બેનિફિટ કરે છે બટ ડિપેન્ડ્સ હાઉ યુ હાઈલાઇટ યોર પેકેજિંગ હવે આટલું બધું મેં કીધું છે હું જરાક મારી બે ચાર સ્લાઇડ્સથી તમને સમજાવીશ નયનભાઈ જયશ્રી બેન પેલું બીજી કરજો ને પેલા એસયુવી પીપીએલ વાળી હવે મેં તમને જે રીતના વાત કરી કે આ હાઇક કરીને કંપની હતી સમજો કે કંપની એ હાઇક વાળાને શું હતું કે એમની પ્રોડક્ટ સ્પ્રે એક્સલન્ટ પ્રોડક્ટ હતી તમે સ્મેલ કરો બહુ સરસ પણ એમનું પેકિંગ આ રીતનું હતું ગ્રે અને વ્હાઇટનું પેકિંગ હતું તો એ લોકોએ વિચાર્યું કે આપણે અને એ લોકોએ માર્કેટિંગ ટીમ સુપર એમને પ્લેસ પ્રોડક્ટ ઉપર એમને હાઇલાઇટ કર્યું સુપર પણ દે નેવર ટાર્ગેટ ટુ યુઝ પેકેજિંગમાં ક્યાં પૈસા બગાડવા ઓન ધ કોન્ટ્રાક્ટ વી કેન ડેવલપ એન્ડ એનીવેર એલ્સ પછી શું થયું નેક્સ્ટ કજો ધેન વોટ હેપન એટલે એક મહિના પછી જે એમનું એક્સપેક્ટેડ સેલ હતું દેટ ડ નોટ એ પૂરું થઈ શક્યું નહીં અને ઉપરથી ઘટવા માંડ્યું જે ઓવરઓલ એમને વેચતા હતા એનાથી આ ઘટ્યું આટલો બધો ખર્ચો વધારી માર્કેટિંગ ટીમ વધારી પ્લેસ નવી પ્રોડક્ટ ડેવલપમેન્ટ કર્યા પછી બી દે હેવ અચીવ નથિંગ નેક્સ્ટ ધેન આફ્ટર ત્રણ મહિના જેવું થયું બટ દેર સેટિસ્ફેક્શન વોઝ ડાઉન દે વેર ગોઈંગ ઇન ધ લોસ તો ત્રણ મહિના પછી બોર્ડ મિટિંગ થઈ અને બોર્ડ મિટિંગમાં ડિસાઇડ કર્યું કે બી નંબરની કંપની છે દેર પ્રોડક્ટ ઇઝ નોટ સો ગુડ એટલી સરસ એટલી આપણા જેથી નથી સારી નથી એમની પાસે સારી ટીમ ટીમવર્ક કે માર્કેટિંગ ટીમ અને નથી એમની પાસે આવી સરસ પ્લેસ તો કેમ આપણું પ્રોડક્શન ડાઉન જાય છે અને બહુ જ રિસર્ચ કર્યા પછી નેક્સ્ટ મેમ એમને આઈડિયા આવ્યો કે વી વેર લેકિંગ ઇન અવર પેકેજિંગ પ્રોડક્ટ ખૂબ સરસ છે પણ આપણી પેકેજિંગના હિસાબે આપણે ડાઉન જઈએ છીએ દેન આફ્ટર દે હેવ ડેવલપ ધીસ આઈ કેચિંગ પેકેજિંગ આઈ કે એટલે બહુ સરસ એનું પેકેજિંગથી થયું તો એનું રિઝલ્ટ આવ્યું નેક્સ્ટ મેમ ગ્રોથ ચાર્ટ ઇન્ક્રીઝ સ્પીડીલી આખો આમ ગ્રોથ વધવા જ માંડ્યો જેમ સાપ દોડવા માંડે ને એમ દોડવા માંડ્યું કે રીચિંગ ધ હિલ્સ નેક્સ્ટ સો દે વેર હેપી અને તે લોકોએ એ લોકોએ જે એમનું ટાર્ગેટ હતું તેનાથી વધારે ને વધારે અચીવ કર્યું સો ધ મોરલ ઓફ ધ થીમ સ્ટોરી ઇઝ પેકેજિંગ ઇઝ ધ મોર ઇમ્પેક્ટ ઓન એવરીવેર નેક્સ્ટ મેમ પેલું ચાલુ અને આ એમના છેલ્લે ગ્રોથ એમનો પ્રેઝન્ટિંગ કંપનીનો પ્રોગ્રેસ બતાવે છે કે આઈડિયા ડેવલપમેન્ટ રિવ્યુ સો ધીસ શોઝ હાઉ ઇટ્સ ગોઈંગ ઓન મેમ નેક્સ્ટ હાય અગેન માયસેલ્ફ ધવલ ઝવેરી ઓફ શ્રી વલ્લભ પ્રિન્ટર્સ પ્રાઇવેટ લિમિટેડ નેક્સ્ટ વી આર હેવિંગ 22 યર્સ એક્સપિરિયન્સ ઇન ધીસ લાઈન પેકેજિંગ અને પ્રિન્ટિંગમાં અમે લાસ્ટ 22 વર્ષથી છે અને મેક્સિમમ ફાર્મા ફૂડ એન્જિનિયરિંગ બેરિંગ ને બધી બધી ઘણી બધી કંપનીઝમાં અમે કામ કરીએ છીએ હું આજે તમને વોટ આર ધ પ્રોડક્ટ રેન્જ યા મેમ દેટ વોઝ ગુડ હા અમે શું શું પ્રોડક્ટ બનાવીએ છીએ એના વિશે હું મારું થોડું ગ્લિમ્સીસ આપીશ અમે મોનો કાર્ટન્સ બનાવીએ છીએ કમ્પોઝિટ કેન્સ બનાવીએ છીએ પેપર કેનિસ્ટર બનાવીએ છીએ પેપર કોર્સ બનાવીએ છીએ અને કુરુગેટેડ બોક્સિસ બનાવીએ છીએ નેક્સ્ટ મેમ હવે પેપર બોક્સિસમાં ઘણી બધી વેરાયટી આવે છે જેમ કે મેટાલિક છે યુવી ડ્રીપ ઓફ છે વાર્નિશ છે લેમિનેશન છે અને એમાંનું આ વન છે મેટાલિક એવા ચમકીલા બોક્સ મળે ને આમ શાઇનિંગ વાળા એ વન ટાઈપ ઓફ આઈ કેચિંગ આ સમર ટ્યુબ છે ઇટ્સ ઓફ એ એક્સપોર્ટમાં આપણી થાય છે ઓન એન્ડ ઓન મા ગુજરાત મા બ્રિંગરા છે ઇન્ડિયા શોપિંગની મેઇન પ્રોડક્ટ છે these are the products which we are and our boxes apne banaiye chhe. Next ma'am. યુવી ડ્રીપ ઓફ બોક્સિસ અત્યારે શું છે કોઈ બી બોક્સ આપણે ધીમે ધીમે રિસાયકલ ઉપર જઈ રહ્યા છે લોકો વાર્નિશ અને યુવી ડ્રીપ ઓફ ને ટાર્ગેટ કરી રહ્યા છે એકચ્યુઅલી એટલા માટે કે નાવ આપણે રિસાયકલ પેપર તરીકે યુઝ કરો કે જેટલું વેસ્ટેજ લેમિનેશન ઓછું થાય એના માટે વી આર ટાર્ગેટિંગ રિસાયકલ પેપર્સ તો યુવી ડ્રીપ ઓફમાં એક બેનિફિટ એવો છે કે તમે હાથ લગાડો તો કરગરી કરગરી તમને ઇફેક્ટ્સ આવે ઇટ લુક્સ વેરી નાઇસ અને એની અંદર જે કોઈ બી આઇટમ્સ જેમ કે ટોટલ છે કે આ સેફકી પસંદ છે that are spotted એટલે આમ શાઇનિંગ બી બહાર આવે અને ડ્રીપ ઓફ ના હિસાબથી એટલે ખરબચડું ખરબચડું લાગે ઇટ લુક્સ વેરી ડિસેન્ટ નેક્સ્ટ મેમ ધીસ ઇઝ લેમિનેશન બોક્સિસ જે આપણે અવેલેબલ હોય છે બધે એ છે નેક્સ્ટ ધીસ આર ધ કુરુગેશન બોક્સિસ મેં તમને જે વાત કરી ગ્લાસ બોટલ્સ છે પછી પેટ બોટલ્સ છે બધું આઉટર પેક કરવા માટે દરેક જગ્યાએ સપોઝ અમારે ત્યાં એમેઝોન નું બી પેકિંગ આવશે ઇટ વિલ કમ ઇન ધીસ કુરુગેશન બોક્સિસ કારણ કે એની એનાથી એની સેલ્ફ લાઈફ વધે છે નેક્સ્ટ મેમ હવે અમે કઈ કઈ ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રીઝમાં કામ કરીએ છીએ જેમ કે ફાર્માસ્યુટિકલ ન્યુટ્રાસ્યુટિકલ ફૂડ એન્ડ સ્પાઇસીસ પેસ્ટિસાઇડ્સ હોસ્પિટાલિટી કોસ્મેટિક્સ અને ટેક્સટાઇલ્સ દીસ આર સમ ગ્લિમ્સિસ ઓફ માય પ્રોડક્ટ્સ નેક્સ્ટ મેમ હવે ફાર્માસ્યુટિકલમાં આપણા બોક્સિસ છે પછી જે નોનીના ટીન્સ બને છે રાઉન્ડ ટીન આવે છે આપણે ટીન એટલે પતરાના ટીન નથી બનાવતા વી મેક ઓફ પેપર ટીન્સ સાયરિંગ બી કરીને જે તમને દેખાય છે એ 200 ml કપ સિરપ આવતી હોય છે એના ટીન્સ છે એટલે અને બોક્સિસ તો તમે મોનોકાર્ટન્સ તો માર્કેટમાં જોવા મળે જ છે તમને એ આપણે મેન્યુફેક્ચર કરીએ છીએ નેક્સ્ટ મેમ ફૂડ એન્ડ સ્પાઇસીસમાં આ તમને એક વોટ ધ નટ દેખાય છે જ્યારે હમણાં રશિયામાં આપણે ફૂટબોલ વર્લ્ડ કપ ફૂટબોલ હતો ત્યાં અહીંયાની એક કંપની ત્યાં આપણે પીનટ્સ આપવાના હતા એની જોડે મારે કોલોબરેટ હતું અને અમે આ પેપર કેનિસ્ટર્સ એને આપ્યા હતા એની સાથે અમારું કોલોબરેશન થઈને વી હેવ સેન્ડ નિયરલી 3 કન્ટેનર્સ ટુ રશિયા ડ્યુરિંગ ધીસ ફૂટબોલ વર્લ્ડ કપ અને એની સાથે આ બધું પેકેજિંગ ફૂડ એન્ડ સ્પાઇસીસ માટે તમે સપોઝ ઇડલી ના મસાલો બેકર્સ પોઈન્ટ એટલે આ જ છે ને કેક માટેના બોક્સિસ બનાવીએ છીએ અને તમે કદાચ જામનગરમાં કચોરીઝ મળે છે એમના ત્યાંના મેક્સિમમ ટીન્સ આપણે બનાવીએ છીએ જે આખા રાઉન્ડ ટીન અને અંદર લાઇન્ડ આવે છે એ હું તમને આગળ સમજાવીશ નેક્સ્ટ વે આપણે પેસ્ટિસાઇડ્સ ના જે હોય છે એના માટે આપણે પેકિંગ હોય છે આ રાઉન્ડ ટીન છે બ્લેક છે રાઉન્ડ ટીન છે પાવડર અંદર પેક થાય છે અને એ જ રીતે આ લોકોમાં બી ફર્ટિલાઇઝર્સ ને પેસ્ટિસાઇડ્સ માટે આપણે બહુ સારા એવા બોક્સિસ બનાવીએ છીએ નેક્સ્ટ આપણે કોસ્મેટિક એન્ડ પર્સનલ કેર આજે ડે એન્ડ નાઇટ છે સાઇન છે એ બધી એક્સપોર્ટ યુએસએ કંપનીઝ છે મેક ઇન ઇન્ડિયા આપણું છે અહીંયાથી ઇન્ડિયામાં પેસ્ટ બની ટૂથપેસ્ટ બનીને વી આર સેન્ડિંગ એટ યુએસએ ધીસ આર ધ સમ ફોટોગ્રાફ્સ ઓફ માય બોક્સિસ નેક્સ્ટ મેમ હા હવે આ કમ્પોઝિટ કેન શું છે હું બે વાર બોલ્યો ત્રણ વાર બોલ્યો એકચ્યુઅલી આ પતરાના ટીન નથી આ છે ને આ પેપર બોર્ડ પેપરમાંથી જ બનેલા છે જે આપણે ક્રાફ્ટ પેપર આવે એમાંથી બોર્ડ બને છે એ એકદમ લાઇટ વેટમાં હોય છે ફિનિશિંગ એકદમ સ્મૂધ એટલે તમે એની ઉપર જે બી ડિઝાઇન કરવી હોય કારણ કે પતરાના ટીન ઉપર એક લિમિટેશન્સ છે કે એને પતરા ઉપર પ્રિન્ટિંગ કરે એટલું જે ક્લેરિટી તમારે જોઈતી હોય એની ઉપર નથી આની ઉપર આપણે એમ્બોસ લેમિનેશન યુવી ડ્રીપ ઓફ બધું ઇફેક્ટ કરી શકીએ છીએ પછી મિનિમલ કોરોઝન એટલે કાટ લાગવાનો બહુ જ ઓછો હોય છે એનો ચાન્સીસ 80% ઇકો ફ્રેન્ડલી હોય છે આ બધી વસ્તુ અને જે તમારા કાચની વસ્તુ હોય છે બોટલ્સ છે કે પછી સીએફએલ ટ્યુબ્સ છે ચીપ્સ છે એકદમ પ્રોપરલી રહી શકે છે ઇન્ટેક્ટ અને અંદર છે ને આપણે લેમિને સપોઝ ફૂડ ગ્રેડ મટીરિયલ માટે વાપરવું હોય ફૂડ ભરવા માટે જેમ કે આ વોટનટ મેં તમે કીધું તો એની અંદર અમે ફોઇલ મૂકીએ છીએ જેમ આપણે અત્યારે જે સિંગ બિંગ મળતી હોય તો ફોઇલની અંદર પેક કરીને આપતા હોય છે ઇન ધ સેમ વે વોટ વી હેવ ડન કે અંદર ફોઇલ લેયર્ડ કરી નાખીએ છીએ અંદર તો અંદર તમારે જે સિંગ ભરે એને એટમોસ્ફિયર ઇફેક્ટ નથી નડતી અને એક આજે અમારું લાસ્ટ વાળું મેં મૂક્યું છે ને એ એલ્યુમિનિયમ ઇઝી ઓપન છે એ તમે કદાચ આ બધા ટીન્સ છે ને તમે જોયા છે તો આપણે કોકો કોલા ને એ બધામાં જોઈએ છે બટ વી આર યુઝિંગ ઇન અવર કેનિસ્ટર્સ ઓલસો નેક્સ્ટ મેમ આ છે પેપર કોર હવે એ છે ને આપણે 1.2 mm થિકનેસ થી 9 mm થિકનેસ સુધી બનાવી શકીએ છીએ એની હાઈટ 8 ફીટ સુધી લાંબી બનાવી શકીએ છીએ આપણે એની ઉપર બ્રાઉન અથવા વ્હાઈટ व्हाइट पेपर अथवा इनसाइड भी व्हाइट अथवा ब्राउन आपणे लई शकीए छे। હવે આ પ્રોડક્ટ ક્યાં યુઝ થાય છે? મેક્સિમમ ટેક્સટાઇલ ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રીઝ કે તમારે જે આપણે કપડું જ્યારે બનતું હોય વુમન થઈ અને એની ઉપર લપેટાય એના માટે આપણે યુઝ કરીએ છીએ। પછી સેકન્ડલી લેમિનેશન છે અને ઘણા બધી જગ્યાએ આપણે યુઝ કરી શકીએ છીએ। નેક્સ્ટ આ પેપરના સેમ્પલ્સ છે જે દેવાંશુભાઈએ કીધું એમને સ્ટાર્ટિંગમાં કે સ્ટાર્ટિંગમાં જ્યારે પ્રોડક્ટ એમની બી જ્યારે બનતી હતી અત્યારે બી આઈ થિંક કરતા હોય છે પણ સ્ટાર્ટિંગમાં એમના બોક્સિસ ગ્રે બેગમાં આવતા હતા પછી આફ્ટરવર્ડ્સ દે આર ડાયવર્ટેડ ટુ વ્હાઇટ બેગ અને નાવ એફબીબી ઇઝ ધેર અને એફબીબીમાં શું છે કે આઈટીસી ની અંદર છે ને ઓલરેડી ફૂડ ગ્રેડ મટીરિયલ જ આવે છે કદાચ આઈસ્ક્રીમ અંદર પીગળી જાય કે અંદર વાસ મારવાના ચાન્સીસ ઓછા રહે છે। સ્ટાર્ટિંગમાં એ લોકો જયારે કરતા હતા ત્યારે ગ્રેબેગની અંદર લેક અંદર કોટિંગ કરાવવું પડતું હતું કે એનાથી ખરાબ નથી થતું અને તમે મીઠાઈના બી બોક્સિસ જોયા હશે કે એની અંદર બી આપણે સિલ્વર ફોઇલ લગાડવી પડે છે। નેક્સ્ટ સો બિફોર એન્ડિંગ બે લાઈન શું આપીશ, આપણા માણસોનો છે એવો સ્વભાવ, જો પેકિંગ સારું હોય તો નથી જોતા ભાવ। થેન્ક યુ।
થેન્ક યુ મિસ્ટર ઝવેરી ફોર સચ એન યુઝફુલ પ્રેઝન્ટેશન। નાવ અવર નેક્સ્ટ પેનલિસ્ટ મિસ્ટર તેજસ નાયર, ક્રિએટિવ ડિરેક્ટર એટ 8 પેટલ્સ ક્રિએટિવ સોલ્યુશન્સ પ્રાઇવેટ લિમિટેડ। Engineering turned admin, started his journey as a copywriter and is now the owner and creative director of 8 Petals. The whole idea of a brand and what effect it has on masses in general and what fascinates him, as he says, is what in his cake. 8 Petals, his agency, is an integrated agency providing 360 degree branding, advertising and marketing services based out of the Ahmedabad. With over 8 years of experience, they have managed to work with 100 plus clients, both national and international. These clients come from various industries like education, real estate, finance, media, FMGC, manufacturing, healthcare, architecture and interior products, logistics, automobiles, IT, government agencies, jewelry, hospitality, and etc. They have worked with several popular national brands like Mahindra Rural Housing Finance, Divya Bhaskar, Wadilal, Sheetal Ice Creams, Jade Blue, Abbott Healthcare, Walmart, etc. I now request Mr. Tejas Nair to give a brief about design as a tool for the business development.
Tejas ji, unmute kijiye pehle.
Thank you, Jalshree. Am I audible to everyone? Yeah, I am expecting that nobody can reply. I'm sorry.
Yes.
So, yeah, so design is not just what it looks and feels like. Design is how it works. This is a famous quote by someone widely recognized and the pioneer of personal computer revolution. Co-founder of Apple Incorporated, and we very recently know that they are the first US company who hit the 2 trillion market cap. And these words are by Steve Jobs, the late Steve Jobs. Now, what is it that comes to your mind when you think of Apple? To me, it is design. Starting from their first Macintosh system to the iPods, to iPhones, iPads, each one of them have been like a design marvel. Whenever you compare it to any other market offering, any other product that is available, you see there is a clear disparity. There is Apple on one side and then there is everything else. So the feel that Apple owner has holding an Apple product is exactly what he pays Apple for. A design-centric company like Apple doing so well, I mean, just kind of makes the perfect base for my talk today. I'll just move on to my next slide, which is design, a tool for business development. Hello and good afternoon, everyone. I'm Tejas Nair. I'm the creative director at 8 Petals. We are a branding, advertising, and marketing agency functioning out of Ahmedabad. And we've been around since 2012. And I've got a very nice introduction, so I don't think that I need to speak much about 8 Petals. But I have been privileged to work with Wadilal. I haven't been able to work directly with Devanshu Bhai, and I've worked with Rajesh sir on his projects, the book that he has come out with, the film that he's made. So I'll just move on with the topic and focus more on the idea of design. And what I understand is we have a very experienced panel and experienced audience. So I don't really want to, speak further on whether design is important or not, because I think all the previous speakers have shed a lot of light on it. What I feel I should more focus on is how really to best apply it. Like what is really a good design? So I'll just take it forward. Now, for everything that I wish to explain, I have certain examples which I'm sure everybody has experienced and can relate to very easily. So once a wise man said, like, there is no alternative to good design. The only alternative is bad design. And there is no such thing as no design. So in the current market, this holds very true and, to the current times, because the customer has become very brand centric. We just heard that the Singdana that you have from the Rekhdi to what you see as a packaged product in pillow packaging to paper cans, they all cost different. So the customer is far more, is very brand centric. He understands design. Probably if he doesn't understand it on the face value, there is a subconscious recognition by every consumer. क्योंकि सबको आसपास आजकल इतना सारा branding और इतना सारा design देखने मिलता है, तो एक design एक अभी बहुत commonly used word हो गया है. आप किसी को भी बोलते सुन सकते हो कि अनु design अटलू मजा नहीं आवी. So design is now a very frequently used word. So I just have a little example here of how people perceive things because of design. So we all know about the famous 7-Up Green. And when they just added another 15% of yellow to the green, and what you see on the right, the two shades of the bottle, the consumer directly started perceiving that it had more lime or lemon flavor to it. Although there was no change in the recipe, the product was absolutely the same. So there is a lot of perception building that happens because of a design. So moving on. So it's not just about packaging, actually. Design moves further to even how you design your product. And the product that you see on your screen, everybody has very fond memories with it. The famous Toblerone chocolate. And this was the first patented chocolate and the first designer confectionery. And the only reason why Toblerone could sustain the competition of Cadbury and Nestle and such giants in the chocolate industry is solely because of its product's design. On the right, you would see there are two different visuals of the product. So actually, the company thought of playing around with the design of their chocolate in 2016, and they increased the space between their those popular chocolate prisms, and they got such a hard backlash. People did not really accept it. That there was a lot of trolls on social media. So immediately they changed back their design to what it was in 2017, and bang, they get their record sales again. So like I said, it's not just packaging, it's also the product. So design kind of turns out to be like a core essential for any brand, any product. So so the question whether design is necessary, I don't think we really need to argue over that. So I, as a person who runs a design agency, I feel so happy when somebody would come up and say, you know, I don't really remember the name, but I remember it was a huge red board and there was a big M which was in a bright yellow color, and I'm very happy. And yes, those are the golden arches, the iconic golden arches. And this is exactly what caught the attention of Mr. Crocs, who took over McDonald's later from the original makers of it. He obviously was very fascinated by the whole process of making fast food and how somebody could make a burger in less than a minute or so. And that obviously was fascinating, but he really loved the feel of the name, the feel of the logo, and it kind of struck him so hard that he really felt that, you know, this is exactly what represents the United States of America, and this is what the people need. I don't know how many of you must have seen the movie, but if you have not, see the movie Founder, which is there on Netflix, which is on the story of Mr. Crocs and his journey in McDonald's. So, and obviously we don't need to speak about the success of the company. They are the second largest employer, and I guess they're second to Subway in terms of the biggest food chain. So, you know, that is the impact of the design. So what is it that you want from your design? So as an agency, you know, I keep getting these briefs, and you know, these words that you see on the screen, memorable hona chahiye, inspiring hona chahiye, bahut classy lagu joye, bahut attractive hovu joye, it has to be unique, there has to be a very good feel good factor to it, it should look premium. So you know, this is all different kind of brief that we get. So I understand that people, you know, with this essence of what you create, the visual that you create has the impact to create, you know, these kind of feelings where it can make you feel good. It can make the product look classy. So, you know, these are just the different kind of briefs that we get. Now, how do you really translate it? So there comes like the important five aspects. These aspects are, to my understanding, I would explain why these five aspects are the most important aspect when you consider any sort of design. I'm not just talking about graphics. I'm not just talking about packaging, your logo. It is basically the entire experience. So these five aspects are basically target audience, the overall feel that you want, the color scheme that you apply, the typeface and imagery, and eventually, every design has to be executed. It has a usage format. It could either be a print ad. It might go on a LED screen. It might be in a newspaper. So there are different usages of it. So keeping in mind these five aspects is what is going to get a wonderful design. So I'll just pick up each of these aspects in one slide each. So first. So if you really want that your design should speak, then you should know who is it supposed to speak to. So that the answer is the target audience. You have two examples. These are two iconic posters. On the left, you see is the recruitment poster for World War I. Everybody knows it. People have seen this famous Uncle Sam image on t-shirts. On the right, you see the World War II recruitment poster, where again, this image till date is used on every Women's Day. It indicates women empowerment. And so just to give you a little brief, the poster on the left, basically the army was looking to do blanket recruitment. They wanted a lot of people, a lot of men actually. So, you know, the iconic figure of Kitchener, the British Secretary of War, and the famous Uncle Sam, they're pointing the fingers at you, you know, from the poster and saying that I want you for US Army. So this kind of created that impact and kind of delivered the reaction that was expected to get out of the design. So it basically wanted to evoke logo mein that spirit of patriotism. Ki aao aage bado, you know, join the army, be a part of the entire war. So this kind of solved the purpose. Similarly, in the Second World War, This time they didn't want basically the men to fight at the fronts, but basically they wanted women to support the industries, वहाँ पे काम करे, to manage the farming so that they could support the main front army. And so they wanted to, you know, basically want a lot of participation from the women. Till that time, women were not really considered to be the part of the main game, you know, and to lead the things. And with this poster, it kind of changed, and women were invited to be a part of the. So, the coming back to the point, you need to know whom you need to target, and depending upon whom you need to target, your design adapts to certain features and to certain behaviors, which agar aap usko acche se apply karoge, to you know it affects. So, just a very simple example, jo aapko sabko screen mein dekh ke realize hoga. If you see the color palette of the images of the posters on the left, and you see the color palette of the posters on the right. So you see a bright lemon yellow there, a polka dotted scarf on the lady, and she flexing her bicep. On the left, you see a more grungy look, a more black and white single tone image of Kitchener, and a very strong expression on the face of Uncle Sam. So यही वो एस्पेक्ट है जो मैं बताना चाह रहा हूँ कि इफ यू नो योर टारगेट ऑडियंस यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट इट वेल थ्रू योर डिजाइन एंड दैट इज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू क्रिएट द इफेक्ट ऑफ द डिजाइन सो जस्ट कमिंग बैक टू द पॉइंट बिफोर आई मूव ऑन टू द सेकंड पॉइंट इज दैट आई वांटेड टू से दैट डिजाइन डज नॉट रियली वर्क आउट ऑफ फॉर्मूलाज देर आर नो figures, there is no multiplication, there is no sine theta, cos theta, and all. Design works by guidelines. There are a few guidelines. And if you follow these guidelines, if you understand these guidelines and add your basic instinct to it, is what is going to give a unique design. It is what is going to give like a design which is memorable, or whatever those list of briefs that we saw in the previous slide. Moving on to the next thing. So first point I spoke about was really the target audience. The second point that I'm speaking about is the overall feel. What is the feel that you want out of the design? So every design can evoke a feel, but depending if you know what feeling it is supposed to evoke. So this iconic image again was made by designer Fitzpatrick. So he did a single tone thing, and the yellow star that you see on his on the Che Guevara's cap is a hand drawn star, and he basically wanted it to breed like rabbits and just spread without any copyright. And today, again, this iconic image is a part of a lot of T-shirts. It is a part. It is an expression of rebel. So wherever people want to rebel, there is a spirit of going against a system. This image of Che Guevara, this poster of Che Guevara, is a symbolic denotation of that. So here the design is basically evoking a feeling, and that feeling is very rightly represented through this poster. I feel so fascinated that somebody has made a design like this, which is working on for years, till date, till 2020, this has so much relevance. So that really is the whole part of the feel. So to know the feel is again very important. Coming to the next part is the color scheme. So it's no more like the childhood games that we used to play, color, color, which color do you want? It is more of a science. Mm-hmm. And well, everybody knows that. So, and so do the customers. So there are 84.7% of customers who basically pick a product because of the color that hits to their eye. So on the image on the left that you see is this chilled can of Coca-Cola with that sparkling red and that dew on top of it. It really waters my mouth thinking, you know, the chilled fizzy drink that I'm going to have within it. And on the right is the light blue Tiffany box. And looking at this box, I'm sure you can get a smile to anybody in your friends and family. So in both this case, you really don't need to know what is within. It hardly matters. I mean, even the Coca-Cola inside is probably lukewarm, and probably Tiffany ke andar, you know, you've just played a prank. It doesn't matter. But this color, this product, this packaging that you see by itself evokes a feeling. It does its purpose. And that strongly is because of the color that they have used. and for the years that they have branded these colors. So very recently, not actually very recently, but we all have observed that McDonald's have slowly shifted from their bright red and the youthful yellow, and their packaging now, like your Mac Maharajas and all those burgers, are coming in white with a slight usage of red. Their interiors have turned out to be more subtle, and they are using, you know, more subtle colors. The very primary reason of it being is that the brand now needs to target adults. So it wants to go beyond the kid segment. So usko abhi adult, and there is a lot of, so we all know that India is basically a place where we have a lot of youth population, but there are so many countries in the world where the youth population is at an all-time low, and the majority of the population are, you know, senior and... Okay, I'll just continue. So they are changing their color scheme from red and yellow to something more subtle to attract basically the aging societies. So the impact of colors. Now coming to the second last point, which is the typeface and imagery. Typeface, bahut shuddh aur simple bhasha mein bolenge to the fonts that you use. Everybody knows the Times New Roman. It is so popular. Ab Times New Roman kabhi bhi dekhte to, you know, you get a feel of it being something very official, something very formal, and something being very classy. So aise ye fonts hai, and the other part is the images, the visuals that you see. Again, I have like two examples over here. The FedEx logo has been like the most magical accident that happened in the history of graphic design. So this designer, Lyndon Leader, he was playing around with his two like favorite fonts, Futura Bold and the Universe 67. And he just happened to keep both the abbreviations Fed and X together. And the arrow just appeared. And, this is the story of this particular logo. So it just came out of accident. But what I intend to say is that magic basically happened because of the fonts that are used. So the fonts play a very important role. Sometimes they give things out of magic, but a lot of science is also involved to the way the fonts represent. And on the right, I'm sure everybody knows who this image belongs to, and you know, and everybody drools over this image, every pizza lover, everybody who likes cheese. And this was made famous by Domino's, and this whole idea of pulling a pie and, you know, the cheese getting stretched was an iconic image which basically changed the whole idea of pizza, and the liking for it was created more stronger in the set of people who loved cheese a lot. And coming to the last part, which I said was the usage format, where are you supposed to use it? So this involves a lot of technicality, actually. So the image that you see on left, I don't really wish to say a lot about it, but it kind of gives an understanding that if the designer who particularly designed this automobile graphics knew the operation of the sliding door and whether the sliding door moves completely back and what is it going to represent. So this particularly comes when you understand the usage of the design. A lot of brands, everybody who do a lot of newspaper ad, they know ki tame Gujarat Samachar ma ad nakho to, you know, you need to use a particular color palette. Tame Times ma nakho to ek particular color palette chale, Divya Bhaskar ma chale, Ahmedabad Mirror ma chale. So, you know, all these newspapers also give a very different kind of output. So it is very important that every time a design is made, you actually know what is the end use of it. You can't really make a design where you don't know the end use. Probably, you know, you might end up doing a mistake which will be criminal. And, you know, this image on the left kind of indicates that. So these were the five important aspects. I felt I would just, quickly run through it. It is the target audience, which I'll just Yeah, so it is the target audience, the overall feel of it, the color scheme that we use, the typeface and imagery, and eventually where you intend to do it. So if these five aspects are considered well and their guidelines are followed, I think there are very less chances of you going wrong with your design. But yeah, to make a memorable design, it basically requires the instinct of the designer, which obviously is innate. So that is why we call this as the field of art. It cannot be worked on a Excel sheet. It cannot be worked on formulas. So obviously the innate quality of the designer plays a very important role. But ye guidelines agar follow kar sakte hain, to there is going to be very less chances of things going wrong. Now, I'll just hit to, you know, what the current scenario is. Like, you know, times have changed, trends have changed, and obviously we were slowly approaching towards like a digital first approach. And now it has become a necessity. After this whole COVID-19 pandemic, people have understood that there is no other way out. You know, before, as an agency, when we had to reach out to our clients, and you know, we actually required to explain the whole importance of application, explain the whole importance of why is it necessary to really promote yourself on social media, to do search engine optimization for your brand, to do digital marketing for your brand, to create digital assets for your brand. And now it has kind of become the necessity. So this little image that you see on the left, the man holding the mobile screen, so that is the real estate that you're getting to represent your brand. Utne se jagah mein, I can currently see there are 5 rows into 5. There are 25 different icons within it. So in that little space, you're competing with 24 other brands if you're one of them. So that is what you need to play for. So here on the right is the logo transition that you see, and very... I don't need to pull on this much because Devanshu sir gave a very apt example of how the Wadilal logo has seen the transition, and that clearly is what is the requirement and the need of the hour. So I've just put up a similar example of Starbucks where you know their entire logo has been simplified, and below is a little snippet of what actually they look like to a person, that little app icon. So अभी आप वो जो पहला उसका लोगो है स्टारबक्स कॉफी टी स्पाइसेस ये सब इसका कोई स्पेस नहीं है. यू नो द आइडिया इज टू क्लियर द क्लटर. सो दैट इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाई द करंट ट्रेंड ऑफ सो मिनिमलिज्म इज नॉट अ करंट ट्रेंड. इट एग्जिस्टेड फॉर लॉन्ग बट नाउ इज व्हेन इट हैज बिकम सो पॉपुलर. एंड द रीजन फॉर इट बीइंग पॉपुलर इज बिकॉज द ब्रांड्स आर फाइंडिंग वेरी स्मॉल space to really represent themselves. So this little app icon, aapka social media ka display profile, you know, those little spaces is where you need to highlight yourself the most, because now you are not really doing outdoor so much, you're not doing print ad so much. So, you know, and you've started selling on online platforms. So if you go on a Amazon platform and let's say you look for something like a green tea and you pop up with 30, 40 different, and you keep scrolling and there are endless amount of brands that you see. So what really strikes you, you know, so that is what is the impact that you need to make with your design. So the times have changed. It's not like before. It's not that you are just, you know, plentiful of brands in any segment. Her industry mein bahut sara competition and there are a lot of players. So things have become very dynamic, and every day there are new brands which are sprouting. So it is very necessary that, you know, the well-established brands maintain that sort of thing, and they're dynamic enough to change to the times. Now, this is the last slide. So bottom of the story, I mean, what really lies now currently is, ye pehle jaise bhi baat nahi hai, you know, people who have, the brands who have a lot of, you know, capacity to spend, they buy more TV time and they do a lot of newspaper ads. It all doesn't work like that. Now every brand requires a brand story. It is the story that the customer accepts, and to put out the story, there is no better way, because story by itself is a you know, it's a amalgamation of thoughts and events put out very creatively, and it requires a creative tool like design to represent the story. And so last I would want to say is how important is story. And I have a little video over here, and it is why I selected this video is one, because I really like the video, and two, it is of a brand which is 122 years old. So the reason why they wanted to tell out their story and the way they have done it is really fantastic. So I'll just play this video. It's a very short video.
There you go, lad.
So that little video that you saw was basically the brand trying to say that as good as what they were back then, they're still just as good. Times have changed. They have evolved too. And in the entire video, you can also see that little transition that happens through the video. And this precisely is what I meant is the power of brand story. So at the end, I would just like to sum up by saying that, however good your brand is, and if it is really that great and the products are so great, then why compromise on the design? Because that is just going to add things up further. And I've put up a little example. I don't know if you find it funny, but you need to keep it simple, you need to keep it effective, and it needs to be timeless. And just like this little safety pin that you see here, so which was invented more than 100 years ago, and probably till date you don't see there is much of a difference to it. People have just made it fancier, but amazing designs are timeless. So thank you everybody, and I really appreciate.
Thank you, Mr. Nair, for such an informative presentation. Now, the platform is open for the discussion and questions raised by our participants. And also, our panelists are eager to answer your raised queries. The very first question for Mr. Devanshu Gandhi. Sir, how essential do you think eco-friendly packaging in the today's generation? Sir, kindly unmute.
Yeah, eco-friendly packaging is very important because the laws are changing, and especially there is a lot of ambiguity in the law for in each state, because most of the packaging today is in the plastic, and there are many states who are banning plastics, and then on, and if they don't ban, then they make sure that you have to the manufacturer has to ensure that the packaging in which he the manufacturing, supplying the product, it is disposed at the retailer end properly. And that is becoming a challenge for each retailer. So eco-friendly packaging will definitely help manufacturer to avoid any hindrances from the government authorities.
Thank you. Sir, this question is for Dhaval Bhai. What is the role and impact of the sustainable packaging for the next 5 years?
Hi, ma'am, can you repeat the question, please?
What is the role and impact of sustainable packaging for the next 5 years?
As I told that packaging depends on the product. So if it is a food products, then we have to use some different type of packaging. And if it is a clothing product or some any other cookies and everything, then we have to use different products. So it can be sustained more than 5 years also due to having some foil work and everything.
This question is for Tejas Bhai. Please suggest some color palettes to use for the skin care brands.
Wow. So, like I said, if there is somebody who is looking for, you know, ready principles, ki skin care brand ke liye ye chalta hai, food ke liye ye chalta hai, or you know, clothing ke liye ye chalta hai. So I think a lot of people know, you know, like red is very energetic, yellow is very youthful, beige is very pleasant, black is very luxury. Aisa ye sara kuch aap type bhi karoge Google pe to ye sara information mil jayega. But my entire essence of saying or talking about design was that it comes from the brand. It is what you would want to represent it to be. It is what story you wish to say. So in the current scenario, you find cosmetics, skincare and haircare brands that come from the royal black of the palette to something which is pastel colors, to absolute white, which is purity. Now, it also depends upon which market you're going to sell your product into. So are you going to sell it to international market? Is it for the domestic market? Which countries do you plan to export? Why I'm asking it is, because सबको ये पता है कि baby girl है तो pink है, baby boy है तो blue है, but did you know there is a country where actually it is the opposite? So the baby boy is basically given a soft pink and a baby girl is given a light blue. So it totally depends of how colors are perceived in the market that you're going to put it out into. So I don't have any fixed sort of a palette that you know, I would suggest, but it would also depend upon your price range of what, how you are going to place your product accordingly. Your color palette or your, you know, your look and feel can be decided.
Sir, again the question is for you. The person is a graphic designer and he wants to know that personal branding, that how do he can do personal branding on Instagram and other social media platforms.
Right, now that is not really a question on design, but I will still give an answer. These social media profiles are basically the one and only platform through which you can represent your art. So it is very essential that you put out what you are good at and what is your forte. So probably if you're good at, you know, playing around with typefaces, put out those kind of visuals. If you're good with packaging, put out those kind of visuals. So the only content that you put out has to be basically what your, it is your created and is your expertise. And then it is necessary, then the basic rules that apply with related to social media marketing, that you require to use all the essential hashtags and make sure that you're also communicating with other designers on the platform. So knowledge sharing, involvement, participation, aap jitna karoge, your profile also would, you know, start getting being seen that much. And the more your profile starts reaching out to people, the more popular you get, the more popular aapka kaam aur utna popular hoga. So yeah, and if you're a freelance graphic designer and you wish to pursue a career like that, I think these social media platforms, especially Instagram, Pinterest, Behance, these platforms are extremely essential for you and they would play a very important role to, you know, reach out to a lot of people.
Thank you. This question is for Dhaval bhai. What is the appropriate and ideal proportion regarding packaging between packaging and material that is packaged?
Ma'am, can you reply? Repeat again, ma'am, please.
What is the ideal proportion with respect to cost between the packaging and the material that is packaged?
Okay. Away. What happens કે એક્ચ્યુઅલી આપણી જે પ્રોડક્ટ છે એની કોસ્ટ તમે જે જોઈ એ પ્રમાણે તમારે એનું પેકેજિંગ તૈયાર કરો. સપોઝ સિંગ છે, ઇફ ઇટ ઇઝ કોસ્ટ 5 રૂપીઝ અને આપણે એને 15 રૂપિયાનું પેકેજિંગ લઈએ, ધેન ઇટ ઇઝ નોટ વાયેબલ. પ્રીમિયમ ક્વોલિટી ઇઝ ડિફરન્ટ થિંગ. લે ક્વોલિટી એટલે આપણે જે ક્વોલિટી એક્ચ્યુઅલી એકોર્ડિંગ ટુ ક્વોલિટી વી શુડ પ્લાન ધ પેકેજિંગ કે વિચ ઇઝ સુટેબલ એન્ડ દેટ ઇઝ અ ક્રોસ પ્રાઇસિસ, એના ઉપર જ આપણા ડિપેન્ડ કરે છે.
સર, અગેન ધ ક્વેશ્ચન ઇઝ ફોર યુ. In online marketing, how is packaging affected since the focus is virtual, not real time experience of the new product?
હવે ઓનલાઈન માટે મેડમ એવું છે કે બધું વર્ચ્યુઅલ જ છે. તમારે સ્ક્રીન ઉપર તમને લુક સારું લાગશે તો જ તમે પરચેસ કરવાનો છો. એક્ચ્યુઅલ તમારી પ્રોડક્ટ કેવી છે એ તમે રિઝેમ્બલન્સ નહીં કરી શકો. હા, જો બ્રાન્ડેડ હોય, સપોઝ કે કોલગેટ છે તો તમને ખબર જ છે કે ભાઈ કોલગેટ છે કે વાડીલાલ છે, ધેટ આર બ્રાન્ડ્સ. બટ અધર ધેન ધેટ વી આર ગેટિંગ ધ પ્રોડક્ટ્સ ઓન અ ચીપર રેટ્સ, બરાબર છે? તો એના લુક ઉપર જ છે. બાકી તો એક્સપિરિયન્સ જો જ્યારે આપણે ત્યાં આવે, ધેન ઓન્લી વી કેન એક્સપિરિયન્સ ઇટ આઉટ.
ઓકે. એન્ડ અગેન સર, ધ ક્વેશ્ચન ઇઝ, હાઉ ડુ યુ સેફગાર્ડ એથિકલ મેસેજ ઇન અ વે ઓફ પ્રોડક્ટ ઇઝ પેકેજ્ડ?
યા, અગેન મેમ,
હાઉ ડુ યુ સેફગાર્ડ એથિકલ મેસેજિંગ ઇન ધ વે અ પ્રોડક્ટ ઇઝ પેકેજ્ડ એઝ વેલ એઝ હાઉ ડુ યુ સેફગાર્ડ ઇકોલોજિકલ કન્સર્ન્સ?
You mean to say about emblem or what, ma'am?
Pardon?
Emblem, ecology.
Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, print, you want, again, can you repeat this question?
Yeah,
because
yeah.
I'm not audible, I don't know.
Yeah. How do you safeguard ethical messaging in a way a product is packaged? As well as, how do you safeguard ecological concerns?
Okay, so branding, જે આપણે પ્રોડક્ટ કઈ રીતના આપણે સેફગાર્ડ, મતલબ એને કઈ રીતના આપણે બધા સેફ કઈ ડિફરન્ટ વે આપણે બચાવી શકીએ છીએ એના માટે, કે એનું કદાચ ટ્રેડમાર્ક કે પેલું પેટર્ન ના થઈ શકે એ બાબતમાં પૂછો છો મેમ તમે?
યસ.
સો બેઝિકલી વી આર ગોઈંગ વિથ સમ બારકોડ્સ એન્ડ એવરીથિંગ, અને સાથે સાથે આપણે જે ફોઇલ ટાઈપના સ્ટીકર્સ આવે છે જેનો ઉપર લાગે છે, અને એના ઉપરથી આપણે સ્ટ્રેસ કરી શકીએ વેધર ડુપ્લિકેશન થઈ શકે છે કે ઇટ ઇઝ ઓરિજિનલ. સો ધીસ આર ધ ડિફરન્સ હિયર.
ધીસ ક્વેશ્ચન ઇઝ ફોર કેતન ભટ્ટ. હાઉ ડુ યુ કન્વર્ટ કસ્ટમર્સ ફ્રોમ વન બ્રાન્ડ ટુ અનધર?
ઓકે, વેલ આઈ થિંક ધ ફર્સ્ટ થિંગ ઇઝ ઓલવેઝ ધેટ કે ભાઈ, ઓફ કોર્સ ઇફ ઇટ્સ અ ન્યૂ બ્રાન્ડ ધેન ઓફ કોર્સ ઇટ વિલ ગોઈંગ ટુ ટેક ટાઈમ, મતલબ ઇટ વિલ નોટ ગોઈંગ ટુ હેપન ઇમિડિયેટલી, ઇટ વિલ ગોઈંગ ટુ ટેક મચ મોર બ્રાન્ડ. વી કેન ટેક ધ એક્ઝામ્પલ ઓફ પતંજલિ, રાઈટ? બિકોઝ આફ્ટર ધ અરાઈવલ ઓફ પતંજલિ, લોકોને ઇન્સ્ટેડ ઓફ હેવિંગ અ ગુડ બ્રાન્ડ દે સ્ટાર્ટ અડોપ્ટિંગ ધ પતંજલિ, બિકોઝ આઈ થિંક દે ફીલ દેટ એન્ડ ધ વે દે માર્કેટ ધ પ્રોડક્ટ દેટ કે ભાઈ ઇટ ઇઝ એબ્સોલ્યુટલી પ્યોર પ્રોડક્ટ એન્ડ ઓલ લાઈક દેટ. સો યુ હેવ ટુ ગો વિથ અ પર્ટિક્યુલર સ્ટ્રેટેજી, રાઈટ? બિકોઝ યુ નીડ ટુ સી દેટ કે ભાઈ જો એક્ઝિસ્ટિંગ બ્રાન્ડ્સ છે ઉસમાં વોટ આર, મતલબ વોટ નહીં હે જો, મતલબ એન્ડ યુ હેવ દેટ પર્ટિક્યુલર એસેન્શિયલ થિંગ્સ ઇન યોર બ્રાન્ડ ઓર સમથિંગ લાઈક દેટ, વેધર ઇટ કેન બી of a quality, it can be another difference maybe on the price or something like that, and you need to, you know, matlab plan your marketing strategy according to that. You can take the good example of Patanjali, I guess.
Sir, again the question is for you.
Yeah,
how to create a smart branding strategy and give some of the examples?
Okay, smart branding strategy, we can take so many examples, you know, I guess. You can take the example of Airtel, right? Because Airtel, I guess, in the last 8 or 9 years before, they just, you know, changed the logo. And way, matlab they, un logo ne branding ke liye jitna advertisement nahi kiya tha na, utna logo change ka jo, matlab logo ko dikhane ke liye jo advertisement kiya tha. एंड अगेन यू कैन थिंक, मतलब आई थिंक ए आर रहमान जी ने उनके लिए बहुत ही अच्छा ट्यून बनाया था, ठीक है, एंड दैट इज अ वेरी गुड स्ट्रेटजी एज वेल. एंड देन मतलब एज फार एज द ब्रांडिंग इज कंसर्न, यू नो, मींस यू कैन टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ नेस्केफे. दे एक्चुअली यू नो डिजाइन वन वेरी गुड नेस्ट एंड कैफे, दे क्रिएटेड द गुड लोगो ऑफ नेस्केफे. एंड व्हेन दे कम टी, दे कम विद द नेस्ट टी. For pharmaceutical also, you can take very good examples, like, you know, मतलब pharma companies में they have a good trend that के भाई तो मतलब जो medicines होते हैं उसमें मतलब first four characters जो है that represent the company and the last four characters या three characters जो है that represent the product. Like if you can take example like Sunich Pharma का calcium का product, they will going to pronounce it Sunical. यदि वही प्रोडक्ट पैरासिटामिल का हो, दे विल गोइंग टू प्रोनाउंस इट सोनी पैरा. मतलब इट्स वेरी इजी फॉर डॉक्टर्स टू यू नो प्रिस्क्राइब एंड राइट द मेडिसिन, एंड इट इज आल्सो वेरी यू नो इजी फॉर केमिस्ट टू आइडेंटिफाई इट इज अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ सुनीच, एंड आल्सो फॉर कस्टमर्स के भाई सुनी काल है तो ऑफकोर्स ये सुनीच का ही होगा. एंड सेम में आई थिंक ट्रॉयका वाला भी, मतलब ट्रॉयका के मतलब कैल्शियम का प्रोडक्ट है, दे विल गोइंग टू प्रोनाउंस इट ट्रॉयकाल. Paracetamol, that will going, they will going to pronounce it Troypel or something like that. So in this way, you can, you know, actually create and develop the good brands as well as the sub brands.
This question is for Tejas Bhai. How do we capitalize a newly created brand identity in sales and marketing?
The first and foremost requirement is to put out your newly created brand identity. So what Ketan bhai gave an example right now regarding Airtel is the amount of spending that they did in terms of reaching out the logo to their existing customers. Airtel had an already huge customer base jinhe unhe batana tha ki ab hum change ho chuke and this is what our new look is. While you are a new brand, people don't really know you. So whomever you reach to, you are reaching them for the first time. And so obviously if you want to reach out the brand, it is very essential that you put out your brand identity, your logo. And I'll just go back to a question that was just previously asked regarding, and you know, when Ketan bhai spoke about Patanjali, this is exactly what needs to be done. So it's not really about which was also the end of my presentation, is your brand story. I mean, it's not just about your logo or how pretty your logo looks or what colors you have. It has to come out with a brand story. So the reason why Patanjali really became the rage in like such a short span and wiped out these huge MNCs who have been dominating the market for such a long time is because of the story that they came with. It's because of the whole idea of being, you know, made in India product. And Baba Ramdev's face to it, giving an entire feel of it being very organic and natural products. And and they are a very typical case study when I talk about Patanjali, is because I really don't find their design to be that appealing. And in comparison to what HUL or other P&G and these brands have put out, their packaging looks, I mean, it looks far substandard compared to what the competitors are, but they are doing extremely well. So, like I said, you know, everything has got a particular weightage. So, I'm assuming the crowd that Patanjali is hitting, the audience who are basically liking Patanjali, is liking them because of Baba Ramdev's face and the impression that he has in the people of him being a yogic and a yoga practitioner himself. So, you know, that whole idea of him, and he has got no stakes in the company. So it is somebody else's. He's merely a face to the brand. So it is the brand story that has, you know, got Patanjali that race. So just coming back to the question, ki aap brand logo, agar if it is a new brand, aap jitna isko reach out karo, jitne logo tak pahuncha sakte, it is all well and good. But it should not be just your logo that is reaching out to people. Make people hear your story. And we are such a huge population, you don't really need to have 1 lakh customers in first, you know, 1 month. You still can reach out to as many people, they believe in your product and they are going to spread your brand by word of mouth. So the story is what is very important, is what I feel.
Jalashree.
Yes.
Jalashree, I would like to add something over here. I'll give you the very good example of Vanilla. They keep changing their packaging design, and also they are changing their logo also from time to time. they are adding some new quality, improve the quality, improve the taste, bringing some new compass of the taste. એટલે જ્યારે આ લોગો ચેન્જ થાય, ડિઝાઇન ચેન્જ થાય, હવે ઘણું શું થાય કે યંગ જનરેશન પાર્ટિક્યુલરલી એન્ડ ધે સી એ ન્યુ લોગો એન્ડ ધે ફાઇન્ડ વી આર ઇટિંગ સમથિંગ ન્યુ. ઇટ એટ્રેક્ટ ધ પીપલ. ઇટ ઇઝ વેરી ગુડ સ્ટ્રેટેજી ઓફ વાડીલાલ. That's all.
This question is for Mr. Devansu. What role does consumer analysis play in the designing product strategy? Sir, kindly unmute.
Sure. Can you repeat?
Yeah. What role does consumer analysis play in designing product strategy?
Of course, consumer analysis is very important, and I always suggest that a research should be carried out by an independent agency first. Give them the proper guideline in what area the research is required, and then take a correct decision. So consumer analysis is most important, and people who are into manufacturing or who are into branding, marketing, they have a set idea, but the research done by the independent agency will give them the correct idea.
Thank you. Next question is for Ketan Bhatt. If you start a new product but do not file a trademark and somebody else copies, if then you go for the trademark registration, what will be the further status?
Okay, so as I said in my presentation, that India follows the principle of first to use. So whoever is actually using the mark first, actually, he will going to get the rights. So even if you have not filed the application in the beginning while launching the brand, but if you have started using it, of course later on you can file the application with claiming the earlier user of the trademark, from the date of using the particular trademark, and you can still file the application with claiming the user, and you can get the protection as well.
This question is for Tejas Bhai. Can you share some tips on how brands can adapt with the pandemic, and what are some things that must be changed to reach out our customers?
That's a nice question, and so what I feel in the current time after pandemic, the customer behavior is not the same as what you probably saw in the early 2020s or the late 2019. They're no more the same. Their sentiment, their emotions have changed, their spending capacity have changed. Their in general perception to life, what they used to enjoy before, what they are enjoying now, and their aspirations have changed. तो काफी सारा प्लानिंग और ये सब चीजें काफी बदल चुका है. सो नाउ यू कैन नॉट बी पुटिंग अक्रॉस द सेम ऑफर्स, द सेम डिस्काउंट, 20% ऑफ, 30% ऑफ, इसके साथ ये फ्री, ये दीज थिंग्स काइंड ऑफ आर रिडंडेंट नाउ. ऑल्दो यू गिव द सेम थिंग, बट द वे यू कम्युनिकेट इट हैज टू बी चेंज्ड. नाउ यू नीड टू बेसिकली get in sync with the emotion of your customer. I was just reading, listening to the Bandhan Bank radio ad that they're playing currently. They completed 5 years. So their radio ad says that we have completed 5 years. Hum birthday celebrate nahi karenge, hum kuch karenge logo ke liye. We will do something for the people of the country. So अब ये क्या करेंगे इन्होंने नहीं बताया, बट द होल पॉइंट बीइंग इज दैट. सो इन जनरल इफ इट वाज अ 5 ईयर सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ अ बैंक, इसका पूरा जो प्रमोशन होता है ये बिल्कुल अलग फॉर्मेट में होता है. द वे दे वुड हैव प्रमोटेड अ 5 ईयर एनिवर्सरी वुड हैव बीन एब्सोल्युटली डिफरेंट, बट बिकॉज ऑफ द करंट ट्रेंड राइट नाउ यू कैन नॉट बी रियली वेरी सेलिब्रेटरी विथ योर कम्युनिकेशन. आप बहुत खुशियां नहीं मना सकते हो, आप बहुत सारा your style of communication has to change. You need to adapt to the sentiments of the people. And that is why Bandhan Bank now says that ki hamara birthday aa raha hai, hum celebrate nahi kar rahe, but hum kuch karenge logon ke liye. So the format of communication needs to change. And you also need to, because this market, this current scenario has given a very clear understanding, is that sab kuch chhoot jata hai, sab kuch reh jata hai. But, you know, so to say, Parle Ji did the biggest business during this lockdown. So, anyways, it was a highly consumed biscuit. But during this time, it just came down to the bare essentials of people. Ye ab wo, sab log ke liye Parle Ji abhi bhi, you know, is like that ultimate brand. So, that product sold the maximum during, in their 80 years of existence, they did the maximum sales during this lockdown period. So that says something ki log are, people are going back to their basics. Basics is the first thing that they would want. So, you know, all these aspects is what you need to consider while you start promoting now after pandemic or during this duration right now. I'm sorry, because I'm speaking right now. Devanshu, sir, I would want to ask you one question. I think everybody, it would be helpful to everyone. You were talking about research when you come out with a new product. I just wanted to ask, is a research also necessary for brands as established as yours? You've been in the market for so long, you've tried and experimented everything. But even today, if you have to come out with a new brand, do you find research to be essential before you actually make the change?
Yes, definitely. If it is a not a brand, but if it is a sub-brand. Brand is, of course, common, so not required to do the research. But if you're targeting a particular segment or a new audience, at that time, research is very much required. Even if in the kind of like in terms of changing the packaging also, the research is required. While we came out with the black color packaging, we did the research and we found that the, if you are introducing the product which contains more more nuts, fruits, more creaminess, then it's kind of a luxury product. So which color is more important? So the research came out that the black color will be preferred by the consumer. Because people, when they look for luxury, they look for a black color.
Right.
And though it was a kind of an innovative, more of a challenging, because in those days, the black packaging was never used by any of the food product, and we came out.
Right. Great. Thank you.
This question is for Dhaval Bhai. Packaging consists mainly aesthetics. That is, it consists morely beautifully.
Actually, look to joiye ja apde, karan ke look vagar koi bhi vastu upadti nahi. But we are concerning about the self life, ane any je andar vastu rahe, any durability bhi rahe, sari rite, ane tut phut na jaye, ena mate it is must necessary. Evu nahi khali look etla mate je ke look thi vastu dekhai je. But we are have to think about the product inside also, ke e એને મેનેજ પ્રોપરલી સેલ્ફ લાઈફ બી સારી અને બધી રીતે બેસ્ટ રહેવી જોઈએ એના માટે લુક ઇઝ ઓલસો નેસેસરી
અગેન ધ ક્વેશ્ચન ઇઝ ફોર યુ સર વોટ આર સમ ઓફ ધ બેસ્ટ પેકેજિંગ મટીરિયલ્સ ધેટ કેન બી યુઝ્ડ
એટ રીસેન્ટ ટાઈમ વી શુડ યુઝ એફબીબી બોર્ડ ધેટ ઇઝ ફોલ્ડિંગ બોક્સ બોર્ડ ઇટ ઇઝ એ જો ફૂડ પ્રોડક્ટ્સ ને એના માટે જોઈતું હોય તો બેસ્ટ છે અને એના સિવાય બી રેગ્યુલરલી યુઝ માટે એની ઉપર જે પ્રિન્ટિંગ ને જે ક્લેરિટી આવે છે It's the best. Emma, ghani badi varieties aave chhe. ITC ane JK wala banave chhe. And many other companies also. But ITC ane JK ne saram sari quality aave chhe. Ultima, Cart Lumina, these are the best qualities. And FBB board is the best at this recent time.
This question is for Ketan bhai. What's your take on the recent brand name change, Fair and Lovely to Glow and Lovely?
Okay, Fair and Lovely has recently adopted to Glow and Lovely, yes. And as a part of their brand developing plan and also in response to the recent news about the, you know, racial and discrimination and protest, I believe the company has found that it is a right time to adopt the change which may, you know, give moral, ethical support from the customer. Also, they, you know, have tried to change this name earlier, I think 6 or 7 years ago, but they failed to execute the same at that time. But I think this was the right.
Sir,
you are lost.
Am I audible now?
Yes.
Yes. So I think, you know, to have the, I think the response to recent news about the racial discrimination. I think to avoid such kind of thing, the racial discrimination and protest, I think they found, they feel that this is the right time to change the name from Fair and Lovely to Glow and Lovely.
Again, the question is for you.
Yeah.
Can you share some of the best trademark examples?
Okay, there are so many actually. Means, you know, I think Coca-Cola is there. I think more than 150 years old brand. You can take the Apple as well. I think it's very famous story that the Apple brand, how they actually adopted, he was using to, you know, eat the apple on that day. And we have one example, very important example here, only Wadilal. It's a very old brand, as Devanshuji said, that it was, you know, more than 1926, it was, you know, as far as Wadilal ice cream is concerned. We can take the example of Reliance as well. There are so many examples are there, you know, which are very, you can say that which are very, very good, and as well as the longest, you know, the oldest trademarks are there.
Again, the question is for you.
Hmm.
What would be the best way to pitch a startup brand in terms of packaging, branding, promotion, and design?
Okay, I think for startup, you know, government has, you know, give so many, you know, relaxation subsidies and all. You can, of course, register your company as a startup company. You can take so many benefits, you know, and relaxation for filing trademark applications, some tax benefits and all. And you can, of course, as far as branding is concerned, you know, startup has to focus more, I guess, on, you know, marketing and all, and social media, on internet and all. I guess that has been, according to me, this is a good idea, you know, to promote your brand, you know, to develop the brand on social media and all, instead of, because nowadays, you know, the radio advertisement and the advertisement, while we are seeing, you know, the checking the status and all on the Facebooks and Twitter and all, even if you are watching the movie on Netflix, Amazon, even on the YouTube, you can have so many advertisement on that. So you can, you know, take that platform for all, you know, brand developing and all.
This question is for Mr. Dhawalbhai. Can you tell us some of the iconic packaging design?
Unmute.
Yeah. Apde iconic, you can, I have already described in my presentation also. Some iconic like Apple is there, then Tiffany and Company, Colgate, they are the icon. They, you see that logo. And you you can તમને આઈડિયા આવી જાય કે ભઈ આ એપલ નું છે એના ઉપરથી તમારો લોગો ડિઝાઇનિંગ ઉપરથી તમારું આખું દેખાય છે બોક્સ બરોબર
This question is for Mr. Tejasbhai. How do you seek a design inspiration and some tips to improve design thinking?
So I always tell to my designers that you know, we are not like independent artist, we are not the MF Husseins, jo, you know, we can create a art of our own, and the people who understand can really be the patron of that. What you do as graphic design is basically commercial designing. So everything that you create has got a commercial viability. It is supposed to solve a purpose. Every design that you create has an eventual goal. It is supposed to do something. So the inspiration part of it, like I said, that there are the five guidelines that I mentioned. So it is very necessary to know that what others in the industry or already existing products have already done, so that you are not reinventing the wheel. So you know what is happening. And like I said, you always need to be different. You always need to be unique. You need to come out with something, you know, while there are all those other products on the shelf and your product is also there, your product has to stand out. So it is very important to know that what are those other products, what other products look like, what are the other competitors in the market doing. So that is a very primary step that you take towards anything that you design, which has got a commercial aspect to it, which has got a commercial essence to it. So one is that. So when you look at a lot of things, you automatically, you know, get a few ideas and understand that what could be done, what differently could be done. So that is one. And then the other is in terms of design inspiration. For me, I have a set, you know, everybody has a different way of working. at least in terms of me, I have a certain principles or certain formats that I am a big fan of. I like that particular style or that particular format, which actually a lot of you know, designers actually designing have. So they kind of take some inspiration from the style or the pattern that they like. You know, somebody might like a Paul Rand, or somebody you know, might like the whole minimalistic way of designing. So everybody has their own style. So your inspirations are caught from there, and your research comes from what your competitors are doing. So yeah, these two are the, you know, primary step towards taking up any particular project.
Again, the question is for you. As you mentioned that minimalizing in design is the trend, how do you see digital marketing and design evolving with technology?
With technology? Okay, what I understand, digital marketing is basically, you know, the outcome of technology. There is no digital marketing without technology. So reframe the question. So how is design going to evolve with the more usage of digital marketing is the reason why minimalism has become a more stronger trend. Like I explained, aapke paas screen bahut kam hai, aapke paas jagah bahut kam hai. You know, you don't have a lot of space like you used to have before. Aap shelf, even while you know you were a product who used to do retail sales, there was a segment that was allotted to you. So wo segment ke andar koi aapse, you know, there is nobody competing in that. But while today on, when you are listing yourself on Amazon, there are 10 different products of the same thing. A consumer searches these online platforms by their requirement. So I would go on this platform and I would look for green tea. So when I look for green tea, I'm going to get all these 100 brands who are giving green tea. Sab ek ke baju mein ek rahega. So, you know, so like I said, this evolution of your sales, which is no more retail, it has shifted online. There are so many brands which are only coming out with online sales. They don't have any format of retail sales. We all know about some brands like, you know, Lenskart and Chumbak and these popular brands from India, who were particularly online brands for a very long time and then eventually converted them into retail sales. And they particularly did that not to increase their sales, but to basically increase their brand visibility. So they, Chumbak started placing their shops in very popular malls, which had, you know, trendy shops. So you would probably see a Chumbak store between Zara or, you know, some other designer label. So that is why they positioned themselves. It was not for sales. They're still doing the maximum amount of sales through online only. The retail part is only to create a brand presence. So the more digital marketing is going to pick up your design sense, your... एक बहुत सिंपल डिफरेंस है. आप पहले जब कुछ एक सिंपल आप जो कलर पैलेट यूज कर रहे थे, यू वर वर्किंग विद द सीएमवाई के कलर पैलेट. टुडे बिकॉज यू आर डिस्प्लेइंग योर डिजाइन्स थ्रू डिजिटल टू डिजिटल इंटरफेस, सो आरजीबी बिकम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. धवल भाई मस्ट बी यू नो अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस होल एस्पेक्ट अबाउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन की तमारू जो पैकेजिंग छे जे स्क्रीन ऊपर बहुत सरस दिखाई रही छे एंड हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू लुक ऑन व्हेन इट इज एक्चुअली गोइंग टू गेट प्रिंटेड. So there is a huge difference. So a lot of products that you see on the screen, they look very flashy, very attractive. But when you actually get the product in your hand, it kind of has a very different feel to actually what you see on the screen. So there is a difference. क्योंकि तुम्हारा color palette is different. चाहे तुम्हें RGB ऊपर काम कर ही रहा हो, तुम्हें CMY के ऊपर काम कर ही रहा हो. So you know, there is a lot of technical aspect that is involved with related to design when it comes to digital platforms. So, you know, it is just going to get more and more technical, and it is going to get, I also fear one thing, it's just a long prediction that I'm making, but design is also a lot of design, majority of design that is going to be used on digital platforms is going to get automated. Ye automated platforms ke through ye designs generate honge. So for example, everybody of you is using a Swiggy platform, a Zomato platform, and so many other platforms. So all those top banners and all those ad banners that you see on the entire platform, no designer is technically making it. It is a very ready-made software where you just pick and drop things and the design is ready. So a lot of design is going to get automated in the future. So so designers, gear up. You really need to get that essence of human involvement in design, something which machines can't do. And that can only be generated by, you know, like I said, your innate ability, your innate quality.
Sir, again, the question is for you. Can you share some of the 2020 design trends and some of the ways to get fresh design ideas?
Sir, I would like to pitch my services to whoever asked this question. I think that is what I do. But 2020 has not really seen a lot of design trends because there are a lot of designs that are not in the market. So it's just about to pick up. But yeah, there are a lot of design trends which were picking due with the end of 2019, which a lot of people must have seen. So there is a lot of flat icons used. Abhi pehle jaise images use nahi kar rahe hain log. There are a lot of vectors and a lot of icons that are being used. There are a lot of flat colors that are being used. There are a lot of gradients that are being used. So these are the trends that are picking up. And you know, sometimes it's just like fashion. Something really old pops up again. So we all know about those pop posters of Marilyn Monroe. Even till date, it is so relevant. Like I had shown in the presentation, the Che Guevara poster. Even till date, it is so relevant. The poster which I showed for the women empowerment, which was used in the Second World War, that figure of that lady, till date, I know on Women's Day, there are so many brands who put out social media posts with that particular female. So designs are basically, there are some designs which are timeless, there are some trends which are timeless, and some things that keep passing by. So the whole idea of vectors and everything being used so prominently these days is because every brand is putting out that many creatives. I think Devanshu Bhai would be able to second me on that. Probably previously, a 10-15 years ago, he must have been vetting every creative that is going in the with the brand logo of Wadilal, because probably in a year you might come across, you know, 1,000-1,500 creatives. But in the current time, every day you're posting on social media on different platforms. So in a year you're creating nothing less than 5,000 creatives. So it is, you know, humanly not possible for him to vet all the creatives which has the Wadilal logo in it. So now the reproduction of design has become very fast and too massive. Abhi pehle jaise kam creative ne banta, abhi creatives ka volume bhi bahut sara bar gaya. So now to use an image every time becomes very difficult. So that is why, you know, usage of colors, usage of icons have increased, because they are easily available. You can easily create it. And we all know doing photography is, you know, so expensive an affair to actually do real good photography. And in the digital age, photography is playing the most important role, especially for things that you eat, the food items. It is the I would like quote unquote Devanshu Bhai. He said that people eat ice cream first with the eyes. So you know, it truly is created by the photography that you do of the product. So you know, agar aapko साल में 5,000 क्रिएटिव्स निकालने और हर एक के अंदर इमेजेस यूज करना है, यू आर गोइंग टू एंड अप स्पेंडिंग अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम, मनी एंड एनर्जी टू डू इट. सो यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट ऑल्टरनेटिव वेज, एंड दीज आर द ऑल्टरनेटिव वेज करंटली एंड द न्यू ट्रेंड्स आल्सो.
द क्वेश्चन इज फॉर धवल भाई. व्हेन अ क्लाइंट इज नॉट श्योर अबाउट हिज बजट फॉर पैकेजिंग, हाउ डू वी कन्वे अबाउट इट्स इंपॉर्टेंस?
First of all, અને એમને ઓલરેડી બજેટ તો છે કે ભાઈ આઈ હેવ ટુ સેલ ધીસ પ્રોડક્ટ એટ 10 રૂપીઝ, 50 રૂપીઝ, 500. સો એકોર્ડિંગલી ધેટ ઓનલી વી કેન મેક ધ બજેટ. અને નહીતર પછી દે હેવ ટુ ગો ટુ સમ લાઈક અસ ટુ કમ એટ અવર પ્લેસ એન્ડ હેવ ટેકન સમ કોટેશન્સ ફ્રોમ લાઈક અસ, દેન ઓનલી વી વિલ બી એબલ ટુ ગાઈડ આઉટ. બીકોઝ વોટ ઇઝ ધ નેસેસિટી ટુ સર્વાઈવ દેટ મટીરિયલ ઇઝ મોર ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ. If seeing some food FMCG products is there or some different product is there, so how we have to conserve it, that is more we know, and it's janvani bahut zaruri hoy che tya pachi je apne decide kari ke no budget ketlu thai shake che. But nominal budget thi mota budget sudhi gamme the possibilities che, but conservation is very much necessary.
Again, the question is for you. Have you created label or packaging for the third party? In that circumstances, who is the actual owner of the said packaging?
थर्ड पार्टी मीन्स इफ आई हैव वन मेन्युफेक्चरर एना त्यांथी कोई मार्केटेड बाय बनावे छे सो इट्स अ थर्ड पार्टी पण अत्यारे मारू डीलिंग मारू मेन्युफेक्चरर्स जोड़े रहे छे दे पीपल जस्ट टेक द प्रोडक्ट त्यांथी डिझाइन्स ने एवरीथिंग त्यांथी लावता होय छे अने दे आस्क अस टू प्रिंट आउट सो अकॉर्डिंग टू मी थर्ड पार्टी इज नॉट मारा जे मेन्युफेक्चरर जोड़े जे डील थाय छे ही विल बी द ओनर फॉर देट
And sir, last, how can be aqua varnish on a cartoon can be tested?
Okay. एक तो first of all aqua varnish शू जे aqua varnish एक water based coating के वाई जे ने अने it is very clear अत्याना time में बद्दा maximum total हम varnish है ना bad type ना बनता हुआ जे एक chemical based हुआ जे जे starting में yellowish तुमने देखा है अने बदले now second is aqua varnish जे आपको water based हुआ जे अबे केवी दे टेस्ट है टेस्ट करवा माटे एक तो जन अमारा लोको माटे तो वी जस्ट सी एंड आईडिया आई जाए कि भाई एनु एक एना छे ने एनी टाइप मा एक तो तमे एनी ऊपर फाटे टेरेबल होय वन थिंग कोई भी कार्टन तमे टेयर करी शको सेकंड इट इज वेरी क्लियर એટલે તમે એના ઉપરથી ખબર પડી જાય કે વાર્નિશ કરેલું છે એન્ડ થર્ડ થિંગ એને તમે કોઈ ભી કોઈન કે એના ઉપરથી ઘસો ને તો એના ઉપરથી કલર નથી જતો ઓન ધ કોન્ટ્રરી જ્યારે કોઈ કોટિંગ વગરના બોક્સ હોય ડાયરેક્ટ પ્રિન્ટ થઈ ગયા હોય અને કોટિંગ વગરના બોક્સ હોય એને ઘસો તો જેમ જેમ ઘર્ષણ થાય એટલે એનાથી એના ઉપરથી કલર નીકળતો હોય છે જો કોટિંગ હોય તો એ કલર નથી નીકળતો એટલે યુવી કોટિંગ હોય તો ઇટ ઇઝ વેરી શાઇનિંગ એન્ડ એને થોડું મેટ ફિનિશ હોય અને પલ ફિનિશ હોય સો ઇટ ઇઝ એક્વા વર્નિશ કેન બી ડિટેક્ટેડ ઇઝીલી
થેન્ક યુ ટુ ઓલ ધ પાર્ટિસિપન્ટ્સ એન્ડ પેનલિસ્ટ ફોર બીંગ મેકિંગ એન ઇન્ટરેક્ટિવ સેશન નાવ અવર નેક્સ્ટ પેનલિસ્ટ મિસ્ટર સૈફુલ્લા મૌલવી who is a trademark agent at HK Acharya & Company. He holds a bachelor degree in arts from Gujarat University. He deals with the trademark applications as well as the registration work related to the trademarks. I now request Mr. Saifullah Maulvi to address this gathering with his vote of thanks.
Thank you, Jalashree. Good afternoon, everyone. Organized by markpatent.org on packaging, designing and branding was indeed an informative and enlightening one. I would like to thank the managing trustee of markpatent.org, Dr. Rajesh Kumar Acharya, for organizing this webinar, which would enlighten businessmen and our attendees at large. Sir has taken this novel initiative of conducting weekly webinars on IP and its legal aspects to help people to gain legal knowledge of IP and its various branches. I would like to thank Sir on behalf of all the attendees. I would like to extend my gratitude to a very distinguished attendee, our guest, Mr. Devanshu Gandhi, Chairman and Managing Director of Vadiral International Private Limited, for giving a thought-provoking speech which set a perfect platform for our speakers to initiate this webinar on an encouraging note. Next, I would like to thank our first speaker of the webinar, Mr. Ketan Bhatt, advocate and trademarks attorney at HK Acharya & Company, for imparting us the knowledge on branding, a tool for business development. Mr. Bhatt wonderfully initiated his presentation explaining us the concept of branding and its importance, especially for business development in food industry. He further explained the need of application or registration of brand names as trademarks for security of one's business. He concluded his presentation giving his suggestions as an expert in his domain. Next, I would like to thank our second speaker of this session, Mr. Dhaval Jhaveri, Director of Sri Vallabh Printers Private Limited, who explained in depth about the uses and benefits of packaging being an essential tool for business development. જે રીતે ધવલભાઈએ કીધું કે ટોટલ ચાર પી છે જે યુઝ થાય છે જે છે પ્રોડક્ટ પ્રમોશન પ્રાઇસ એન્ડ પ્લેસ જે ફિફ્થ પી છે જે પેકેજિંગ રિલેટેડ છે જે અત્યારે હવે જ લોકો યુઝ કરવા ઈચ્છે છે ઠીક છે ફર્ધર I would like to thank our third speaker of the session, Mr. Tejas Nair, Creative Director of 8 Petals Creative Solutions Private Limited. Mr. Nair gave a very useful and important presentation on designing a tool for business development. I would like to thank our co-organizers, Gujcoast, Department of Science and Technology, CED, JITCO, GNLU, Institute of Law, Nirma University, LD College of Engineering, and Gujarat Chemical Association, who have helped this webinar on being a successful one. Lastly, I would like to thank our attendees who have patiently been a good audience throughout the session and without whom this webinar would not have been possible. Thank you very much, everyone. We hope to have such a successful and beneficial webinar in future weeks as well.
Thank you, Mr. Seth. In closing, I wish to express my gratitude to all the panelists and participants with their full cooperation. It offers me a chance to commemorate our success in pursuing excellence in the field of IPR. We are privileged to have an attendees, such distinguished experts as well as observers. Having such resourceful and knowledgeable panelists, we have helped us gain insights on strengthening mechanism as a means for promoting IPR. With this, we sum up our session. Wish everyone to stay home and stay safe. Thank you for joining us, ladies and gentlemen.